on these guys like Pearson and Joubert, and we could name five others, that when they get those opportunities, they have to make something happen. And he did that this weekend.
There's a strike with a take on, 3-1. So a steady diet of fastballs here to Josh Pearson.
Yeah, the scouting report said that he would throw a lot of breaking balls. But you're right, so far we've seen the heater most often.
3-1, off the end of the bat, into the screen, foul off the bat of Pearson. That'll make it, again, 3-2. Fills the count. Pearson batting .259, just his 28th plate appearance of the year. As I mentioned, he's got 10 runs batted in. Also with 2 doubles on the season. Here's the payoff delivery. This one slapped to right field. Base hit. Going to get down in front of Colby Johnson. So Pearson with a leadoff single. What else can you ask from your leadoff man? Runner aboard here for the Tigers. And we'll see Dylan Cruz, who has been Mr. Everything as advertised, batting .508 through 20 games this season.
Oh, it's off the charts.
I joked with Bill Franquez on Saturday morning, Doug. I said, I got a text from Duder. It was early, and he was already breaking down Dylan Cruz's numbers, his walks to strikeouts, beyond all the other things he's done.
Well, you know, in a house with three boys, you rarely get those quiet moments with the coffee. And I was scrolling through some of those stats, and that one almost gets the front hip, Cruz out of the way. But, man, how many times have we talked about it over the years? Wow, this guy's got more walks than strikeouts. You just rarely see it. I'll count both teams to tell you how many players have more walks than strikeouts, and then we'll tell you how many Cruz has. Oh, my goodness.
This one hit high in the air to right center field. Seldom Ridge and Johnson going back, and it's over the wall. See ya. Well, we mentioned his walks to strikeouts. How about his home runs, too? He can do it all. And LSU takes a 2-0 lead here in the bottom of the first inning as Dylan Cruz with his 6th homer of the season, RBI 24 and 25. We're here worried about walks and strikeouts. He's just going yard.
Well, I tell you, all the young hitters, if you're watching at home on TV, hit the rewind button. Try to get the good view from home plate. Watch that swing over and over and over. Dream about it. Try to duplicate it. Because when you can hit a ball for power to that part of the field, you're doing a lot of things right. He is so good at letting the ball travel.
Now we'll see Tommy White. He's got 6 homers on the year. The right-hander breaking ball misses outside with the slider, and it's 1-0. White leading the team with 34 runs batted in. Second in the SEC with that RBI total. Here's the 1-0. He takes a big cut but fouls it into the screen. Evens the count, 1-1.
Yeah, Tommy White hit a cool .500 at College Station, 7-14 over the weekend. 7 RBIs.
Another guy who certainly shows power to the opposite field. This pitch floats in high. 2-1 the count to White.
It's so oftentimes a guy comes in with a lot of hype, whether it's a freshman, a JUCO guy, or in today's world, transfer guy. And this guy came in with a ton of it, but boy, he's lived up to it.
2-1, big swing, can't find it. It evens the count 2-2. That's why Jay Johnson had me laughing Friday before the game. And he was serious, but it caught me as funny. I talked about Tommy White the week he had previously. He said, yeah, you know, I thought he was a little underrated as a hitter. And he transferred in. Here's a swing and a miss. Chased the slider. Comes up empty. And White down on strikes. One away as Loftman records his first K.
Yeah, that was on me. I was just talking about how great of a hitter he is.
Now we'll see Trey Morgan. Trey had been in the 2 spot. Moved to the cleanup hitter. Batting .286. Semi-shift with the left-hander at the plate. He goes opposite field. Takes it into left center field. First pitch he sees. And a one-out single as Morgan aboard. LSU leading 2-0. Now their 3rd hit off of Loftman here in the bottom of the 1st.
If you ask any good hitter what they're trying to accomplish up there, they'll tell you 2 things. I'm trying to hit the ball in the middle of the field, and I'm trying to change the scoreboard in some way. And Trey Morgan, that first part about hitting the ball up the middle of the field, I mean, it seems like it's just effortless for him at this point. We've seen him do it since the first day he stepped on campus. He is so good at staying on that ball back up the middle.
Gavin Dugas will stand in. First pitch he watches. It drops low with a breaking ball, 1-0. Dugas batting .379. Maybe we don't talk about Gavin enough. I mean, he's had big moments already this year, but this lineup top to bottom. Take your pick. Batting in the five spot here, and that pitch again staying low, misses for ball two. 2-0, as Gavin's got five home runs, three doubles, driven in 17 runs on the year. And batting 375 with runners aboard. Morgan at first with one out. The 2-0 launched to right center field. Seldom Ridge on his horse at the track, reaches up.
Nice play.
And able to hold on. Did he drop it?
Morgan, no, Morgan just, he did. Morgan had to have thought he dropped it,
yeah,
because
he
never checked up.
He made the play and went into the wall. Morgan kept running, never checked up, and LSU doubles themselves up. He was already at third about the time that Seldom Ridge made that spectacular play, went slamming into the wall. Morgan just kept on churning, so that'll end it for LSU. But they get two runs on the board thanks to Dylan Cruz, two-run shot to right center field. It's a 2-0 lead. Central Arkansas comes to the plate. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Albertsons is making shopping and saving easier than ever. Just For You Deals is now Albertsons For You. It's everything you love about Just For You with all new perks. Get rewarded for just being you, including personalized deals, a free item every month, and even a treat on your birthday. With Albertsons For You, you earn points every time you shop and redeem them for discounts on groceries and more. Brand new Albertsons For You members receive $5 off their next $25 or more purchase just for signing up. Download the Albertsons app or simply update your existing mobile app to see your all new, all awesome perks. Albertsons, fresh foods, local flavors.
Excuse me, do you know the average time of one full inning at an LSU baseball game?
10 minutes. Half an hour?
I think 45 minutes.
Actually, one inning in baseball lasts about 20 minutes. Any idea how long it takes to complete a mortgage application?
I'm going to go with an hour and a half. I think it's about 2 hours.
Probably a couple days.
Actually, at Assurance Financial, you can apply for a mortgage in less time than one inning. Wow. Find out more. Visit them at assurancemortgage.com. That's assurancemortgage.com. Equal housing opportunity. NMLS number 70876.
It takes true grit to wake up every morning dedicated to a higher standard of work. At H&E Equipment Services, we're leveraging our national fleet of equipment with a local approach, working closely with customers to understand their needs and provide them reliability, fair prices, and the support of a first-class service team.
Taylor.
We're an equipment company run by equipment people. Where others stop, we continue. H&E Equipment Services, the higher standard in equipment rental, sales, parts, and service.
Your home for LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball. This is the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Tigers lead 2-0 over Central Arkansas. Dylan Cruz got the Tigers on the board with a two-run homer. It'll be Halfley to lead it off for the Bears as Money drops one low. They appeal down to first. They say Halfley could not hold back, and it's nothing in one. Halfley, the senior, batting 219 so far this year on an Central Arkansas squad going 11-8. The 0-2 popped up, but foul out of play left side.
Yeah, that check swing was a tough call. I'm not so sure that he actually went around. And Blake Money started this one off again with a breaking ball for a strike right down the middle.
Dugas playing just right of second base. Morgan almost halfway between first and second with the right-handed Halfley at the plate. This breaking ball misses outside. One ball, two strikes to Halfley. The cleanup hitter plays first base. His 19th start of the year. Money's 1-2 pitch. Right back up the middle. Dugas, though, there in position, dropped it at first, but then picked it up and able to get it to Morgan in time. He was in perfect position just right of second base. Halfley hit it. He had to move a little to his left, and nice recovery to pick it up and finish the play.
Yeah, well, Dugas was moving to his left. That ball had some spin on it right to left, so it took a weird little bounce there when it got to the hop. But a nice job there by Dugas. You see so many young players, when they don't field it cleanly, they'll panic and add to that mistake by throwing one way over the first baseman's head. But Dugas threw a catchable ball.
A.J. Mendolia takes a swing and fouls a dribbler down the third baseline. Nothing in one. Mendolia out of Fort Worth, Texas. Junior third baseman. Impressive 438 average on the year.
Yeah, this is their guy.
Breaking ball in for a strike from Money on the inner half. Nothing in two.
And that's not, you know, started nine games. He started all 19 games out there. 28 hits on the year, 64 at-bats. It's pretty dang good.
The 0-2 from Money misses down and away. 1-2. Not a bad 0-2 pitch, but Mendolio stays away. Wind blowing slightly here, right to left towards the scoreboard and left center. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss. Elevated that one slightly. The fastball at 92 gets by him. And there are two gone as Blake Money now with his first Super One Food strikeout of the night. And we'll see Dylan Sear, the left fielder.
And that's what you'll see happen a lot with a guy that's able to get that breaking ball over early in the count for a strike. Later in the count, that it's in the hitter's mind that when they see that spin, they're going to swing at it. And that was a great fastball there from Blake Money. Another one there to start this one off at 93 miles an hour.
Right in on the hands, a little below the hands. Not much you can do with that if you're Sear, and it's nothing and one. Right-hander comes to the left-handed hitter, and that time, again, right over the plate. 92 on the gun, jumps ahead, nothing and two. Blake Money looks like a man on a mission here.
He does.
Blake gets the sign. He likes it. Here's the 0-2. Again, tried to catch that inside corner. This time just a tad off, according to Jeff Beeman, our home plate umpire.
You know, if you're really a player, then competition's going to bring out the best in you. Because of the thick lineup, the thick, deep bullpen, guys like Blake Money take these opportunities very seriously.
1-2, off speed, drops in low. Good eye by Sear to even the count now, 2-2. A reminder, Capital One offering checking and savings accounts with no fees or minimums. What's in your wallet? With two outs, the 2-2. Ground ball foul to the first base dugout of the Tigers. LSU scoring two runs there in the bottom of the first inning. A rare base running mistake by Trey Morgan on a really deep fly ball off the bat of Gavin Dugas, but a sensational play by Seldomridge in right center. And Morgan was already around second, and he was at third when they tossed back to first to double him up. The 2-2 sent back into the screen as Sear just missed that one.
Yeah, you have to give him credit. He was on his horse, but gets a little weird out there. First of all, that ball was hit to the deepest part of the park right there at the McDonald's sign out right to the right of the 405. And it's real bright, like the sun's shining brightly on it. So I really do think Morgan just lost it as it came down right there. What a great play by the center fielder.
2-2, swing and a miss on a pitch up and in. Off speed from Money records his second strikeout presented by Super One Foods. And again, quick work of the Bears here in the top of the second. No runs, no hits. Nobody gets on base. We now move to the bottom of the second. It's a 2-0 LSU lead. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
My husband had a gun. Him and his friends would go shooting. The ammunition, unfortunately, was not stored separately. In a million years, we never thought that Emily could. There's a hole in our family that can never, ever be filled.
63 Americans a day die by gun suicide. With safe gun storage, we can give our loved ones a second chance at life. Learn more at endfamilyfire.org. Brought to you by Brady and the Ad Council.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Put a frog in boiling water and it'll jump right out. But put a frog in cool water and slowly heat it up, that frog will boil. As veterans, we tell ourselves the lie that we can handle anything. We let the water boil. You are not a frog. If you or a veteran you know needs support, don't wait. Reach out. Find resources at va.gov/reach. That's va.gov/reach. Brought to you by the United States Department of Veterans Affairs and the Ad Council.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
LSU leading 2-0 over Central Arkansas. We go to the bottom of the second. Jared Jones, the freshman, to lead it off. Designated hitter for the Tigers. Loftman ready to go, and he fires. And a swing and a miss as Jones unable to find the bat on that one. Nothing and one. Jared comes off another nice weekend in his freshman campaign. Batted 462 against the Aggies this past weekend. Season average at 367. The 0-1, a strike on the inside corner, and he falls behind nothing and two with a couple of breaking balls from Loftman. Jones also had the only home run for the Tigers in a ballpark that was extremely windy all weekend long at Bluebell. The 0-2 ground ball, but left of third base, and it will be foul.
Yeah, wind, rain, not sure. There's many external factors that can keep the ball in the ballpark when he squares one up.
On Saturday, as I mentioned on the broadcast, hurricane force winds would not have stopped that one. It was an absolute dart. The 0-2, tapper again up the third baseline, foul. Friday night, there were a number of shots for both the Tigers and even the Aggies that off the bat looked and sounded like they would get out of there. That wind was howling in towards center, from center field to home plate, no chance. The 0-2 stays away on a breaking ball, and it's now 1-2 to Jones. Jared, team leading 7 home runs on the year. Here's the 1-2, takes a hack, fouls it into the screen right side. Still 1-2.
So the total number of players on both rosters with more walks than strikeouts is 5. Okay. Dylan Cruz has 23 walks and 10 strikeouts. The next closest on LSU's team is Trey Morgan with 10 walks and 8 strikeouts.
1-2 is fouled just above the head of the Tigers in the dugout. Everybody dropping down. Luckily missed everybody. Still 1-2 to Jones. We were talking about his on-base percentage, and I brought up the fact that you took note of the 22 walks to 10 strikeouts and also the 3 hit-by-pitches.
Yeah.
Here's the 1-2. Good eye by Jones as that one dropped low and away. Breaking ball evens the count now 2-2.
Yeah, Cruz's is 648. Both rosters, the next closest is 532. That's Dugas.
2-2 to Jones. Again, fouled back. Little battle here between Loftman and Jones as Jones got behind in the count, but he's worked it even and he's fighting pitches off. Anything close, he's putting a bat on.
That's 4 or 5 foul balls now with 2 strikes.
Loftman will try it again. The 2-2. Slap and fair inside the third base bag. Got by a diving Mendolia. Jones around first as this one went all the way to the wall. Sear just now getting it back in. And after a battle and multiple foul balls, this time Jones lines it up, gets a double down the line, and the leadoff man once again aboard for the Fighting Tigers.
Yeah, they only show the off-the-bat miles per hour on home runs, unfortunately, because I'm just glad the umpire got out of the way. That was enough to break a femur down there down the line. He hits the ball so hard.
Now we'll see Braden Joubert. Jay Johnson telling us before today's game, hey, look, went with Josh Pearson last weekend, along with Paxton Kling, high on Braden Joubert. Got to get him some at-bats, got to give him some action. So he gets the start tonight in left field. He'll bat for the first time, and the first pitch is strike, and it's 0-1. Joubert, his 45th plate appearance. He's batting 250. 4 home runs, a triple and 2 doubles. He's driven in 12. He's got Jones down at second base. Tigers up 2-0. Chance to add to the lead here with nobody out. Is that pitch low, evens account 1-1.
Yeah, I mean, Joubert, you know, for probably 8 other SEC schools, maybe 10, is hitting in the 3-4-5 hole. This guy can really change the scoreboard. 18 home runs last year.
Loftman's 1-1. Swing and a miss. Make it one ball, two strikes to Braden.
We're seeing a lot more off speed here in this inning than we did in the first.
Maybe Loftman wanted to test out the top of the order there with the fastball, and then after Cruz took it over the right center field wall, he said, let's go back to what Coach said.
Yeah, let's change up back to what we do.
Here's the 1-2. This one absolutely hammered. Base hit to right field. Jones on his way into third. They'll hold him up there. But a double, now a single, nobody out. LSU with runners on the corners here in the bottom of the second inning.
Yeah, it's really been an impressive round of batting practice, really, off the bat. Tigers have Pearson hit his ball solid. Cruz hit his in the middle. Morgan, a line drive right back up the middle. Jones almost killed the umpire down the third baseline. And that ball, another line drive. So five hard hit base hits. You see five hits after two innings, maybe a C&I single here and there. Nope, none of that. Not so far.
As Jordan Thompson stands in, time going to be called. And Noah Argenta, the catcher, wants to go out check on Loftman here. They'll have a quick meeting. As Thompson stands in, batting 270. 3-for-13 against the Aggies. Did score a run, did drive in a run. Hitting 270 on the year. Again, we know what he can do, and he's one of those guys that you go back to that run, to the Super Regionals, that trip out to Oregon in the Regionals, he was able to have some clutch hits, some power that LSU desperately needed. We've seen it throughout his career.
Well, again, 270 with the way he's playing short. We have a mound visit now. Looks like they'll maybe go down to that left-hander. No indication yet. But, you know, 270 with the way that he's fielding it out at shortstop, you'll take it all year if he's able to stay at that clip. You know, that shortstop position is the most important on the field because the most balls get hit there. And he has handled it well this year. You know, Jay Johnson, such a pulse for this team. Before he even threw the first pitch of the season, was talking about some things that we would see, and that improved defense overall was one, leading the country, by the way, and that Jordan Thompson had put in a lot of work, and specifically we would see his play improve, and we have. So really happy to see that because he's got a lot of skill out there at shortstop.
No question about it. A couple of plays this weekend. If he doesn't have the arm he has, those plays aren't made. They do make a call to the bullpen. Pitching change powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. We'll get you the new name, his numbers, and get back to action. LSU leading 2-0, nobody out. Runners on the corners here in the bottom of the second. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Hey, Tiger fans. Don't miss out on the latest John Deere deals from Sunshine. Ask us about tractor packages with 0% financing available from Alex Box Stadium to your own backyard. The grass is always greener behind the wheel of a John Deere. Learn more at sunequip.com. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer ends May 28, 2023.
Albertsons is making shopping and saving easier than ever. Just For You Deals is now Albertsons For You. It's everything you love about Just For You with all new perks. Get rewarded for just being you, including personalized deals, a free item every month, and even a treat on your birthday. With Albertsons For You, you earn points every time you shop and redeem them for discounts on groceries and more. Brand new Albertsons For You members receive $5 off their next $25 or more purchase just for signing up. Download the Albertsons app or simply update your existing mobile app to see your all new, all awesome perks. Albertsons, fresh foods, local flavors. Support your LSU Tigers with Hancock Whitney, the official bank of LSU athletics. From game day to the offseason, Hancock Whitney LSU credit and debit cards are a big win for any Tiger fan. Want to get your paws on these cards? Well, apply online or visit hancockwhitney.com/LSU. Hancock Whitney Bank, member FDIC. All accounts subject to credit approval. Terms and conditions may apply.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Back to action here in the bottom of the second inning. LSU so far 2 runs on 5 hits. They got runners on the corners here as Jordan Thompson going to lead things off. Yannick comes in, a left-hander, and before he comes to the plate, he'll throw over to keep an eye on Joubert at first base. Jones would double down the left field line off Loughman to get things started. Joubert would light one to right field. Here's a swing and a miss by Thompson on an off-speed delivery low, and it's nothing and one. So Dylan Yannick takes over for the Bears.
Yeah, Yannick, 6'1", 190 pounds out of Butler Community College by way of Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
Here's the 0-1 to Thompson, off-speed in on the hands, and Jordan wants that swing back. 76 miles an hour, just kind of floated inward. He went around, it's nothing and two.
Yannick had 12 appearances last season. 14 the year before. He actually only spent 1 year in junior college.
Runners first and third. The 0-2 to Thompson. Another breaking ball way off the plate. Thompson swings and misses down on strikes, and there's one away. Here in the bottom of the second, Tiger fans, remember StubHub, the easiest way to experience every Tiger game. Check the virtual view, score your seats, get your tickets delivered instantly. StubHub, the official ticket marketplace of LSU Athletics. StubHub, be there. They want to check StubHub for this weekend, that Arkansas series beginning on Friday.
Yeah, those tickets kind of tough to find, I hear, huh?
Last I heard, standing room only, and that was a week ago. There's a sidearm throw to first again to keep an eye on Joubert. Alex Milazzo to the plate. Again, Alex getting the start tonight behind the plate. Another one that Jay Johnson said, hey, look, we got to find time for Alex. He's too good. This is his 13th start, 20th appearance, and he shows bunt, pulls it back. The pitch from Yannick is low, and it's 1-0.
You know, Yannick may be a challenge for this LSU lineup, at least the first time through. Everything is slow, slower, and slow. His fastball is going to get up to 85 max. Slider will be in the mid-70s. Changeup, same thing.
Here's a bunt right of the mound. Yannick going to go for it, glove it. His only play is to toss it to first and just caught Milazzo. Jones will come in to score from third. So Milazzo does his job, advances the runners, a run in. That'll make it 3-0, and down to second goes Joubert. But Milazzo made that a lot tougher as Yannick kind of slowly made his way, gloved it, then kind of brought the glove up and then said, okay, I guess I better flip it to first. And, Milazzo.
Yeah, that was an aggressive underhand flip. He didn't realize Milazzo was hustling so hard. Almost spazzed out and threw it down the line there.
Two outs, Joubert at second, 3-0 LSU leads, and we'll see Josh Pearson, top of the order. Had a base hit back in the first. There's a strike at the belt. Off speed again, nothing and one. But Milazzo, Jay mentioned, he said, hey, look, I know this Central Arkansas team, if they get on base, they're going to want to run. They want to be aggressive. And best way to neutralize that is with Alex Milazzo behind the plate. The 0-1 misses outside. One ball and one strike, which, again, go back to the options LSU has in 2023 they did not have. In 2022, starting with the fact that Milazzo was injured the majority of the year, but you're going to face teams that will be aggressive down the road, certainly in SEC play, and it's nice to have that option if you need it. Here's one swatted up the middle, again with the shift on. Bowman, the shortstop, able to field it right of second base and throw to first in time to get Pearson for out number three. But LSU adds to their lead, one run on two hits. They leave one man on. We go down to the top of the third. 3-0 Tigers. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
When you open a crisp, cold Bud Light, you know game day is here.
Touchdown! You owe me $5.
We mean every sound. Enjoy responsibly. 2022 Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
It's good to be able to make a change, to never feel stuck. That's why at Cox, we're making a change too. Now Cox Internet plans are flexible, so you can choose to just go with Internet, add TV tomorrow, or home automation down the line. It's easier than ever to get just what you want and nothing you don't. Flexible plans from Cox. Change anytime. No commitments, no penalties. See for yourself at cox.com/internet. Additional services can be added at then current regular rates. All services subject to residential customer service agreement and acceptable use policy. Restrictions apply.
Y'all like it hot and spicy? Then play Boil 'Em Up from the lottery. Win up to $3,000. You've hit the bonus round. Play Win It All Bonus. Win up to $17,000. Looking for a jolt of cash? Pick up High Voltage Bingo and win up to $30,000. Stack up your winnings with $200,000 stacks. Top prize, $200,000. The Louisiana Lottery, giving you a reason to smile. Must be at least 21 to purchase.
When you open a crisp, cold Bud Light, you know game day is here.
You owe me $5.
We mean every sound. Enjoy responsibly. 2022 Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball from the LSU Sports Radio Network.
3-0, your Fighting Tigers lead here on this Tuesday night. We go to the top of the third inning. Central Arkansas will lead things off. Noah Argenta, the catcher, will bat for the first time. It's Blake Money ready to work. Delivers the first pitch. Miss low. Ball one, 1-0. Argenta, a .229 hitter on the year. 36 plate appearance. This pitch again low off speed. Two balls and no strikes. Bears coming off a sweep of North Alabama to move 3-0. A-Sun action off the end of the bat. Argenta sends this to right field. Josh Pearson, though, over. Gets underneath and makes the play for out number one. Argenta retired, one gone here in the top of the third. Of course, much was made when Tiger fans saw this game coming up that back on February 21st, they went to Nashville, beat number 10 Vanderbilt 5-4. Of course, Vandy coming off a very successful home series, sweeping the national champion Ole Miss Rebels this past weekend. Now we'll see Reed Bowman. And Money sets him up with a first pitch called strike off speed, nothing in one.
Yeah, Ole Miss got swept. How about Tennessee getting swept by Missouri? That didn't make the weekend any worse.
The 0-1. Missed outside from Blake. One ball and one strike. It was really odd. Bill Franquez and I touched on it Sunday. Again, LSU unable to complete the sweep, but there were a number of sweeps.
Yeah, five.
In conference play with, again, maybe the most talented SEC we've seen top to bottom in a while. Is this one, again, just outside, missed the outside corner. It's 2-1 now to Bowman.
Yeah, Auburn, Ole Miss, and Mississippi State in the Western Division started out 0-3, and Georgia and Tennessee both 0-3 in the East.
The 2-1 slapped in the air, popped up, first base line in fair territory. Morgan calling for it, and the Tiger first baseman will have it for out number two. That'll bring Tanner Leonard to the plate, the number 9 hitter, batting .323 for the Bears. Blake Money, some help from this defense, just moving along here. Tigers got Dylan Cruz to get them going with a two-run homer there in the bottom of the first inning. Jared Jones would get aboard on a leadoff double. He would eventually come around to score that third run in the bottom of the second frame. The breaking ball misses a tad high to Leonard, and it's 1-0. Pitch, breaking ball that time for a strike. Got it down a little bit, and it's 1-1.
How about LSU leads the league in runs scored? And they're 12th in the league in at bats.
The 1-1 went around on a pitch down in the dirt. Now Blake Money ahead in the count now on Leonard. One ball, two strikes. Tigers got off to a great start at Bryant College Station. 9-0 shutout. Their seventh nation-leading seventh shutout of the season. As Money misses high with this one, 2-2. Then really came from behind, got down early, 4-0 to A&M on Saturday. And then the onslaught would begin, 6 runs in the top of the fourth, and that was all she wrote. Two outs. Here's the 2-2 to Leonard. Stays alive, fouls this one off. Rolls to the on-deck circle of the Tigers, still 2-2. And then got a 4-run lead in the top of the first inning. First 4-0 lead LSU has surrendered under Coach Jay Johnson. 2-2 pitch. Again, hit foul into the screen down the line in right. Before that, the 3-run deficit Southern Miss overcame in the regional last year, the most anybody had come from behind against LSU under Jay Johnson. Here's another 2-2 pitch. Leonard puts a bat on it, ground ball to short. Thompson will scoop it up, pump fire to first, and uses that electric arm to record out number three. So that'll do it for the Bears. Once again, they go in order in the top of the third. No runs, no hits, nobody on base. We go to the bottom of the third. LSU leading 3-0. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Jelly. Jelly adjective. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous. As in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same. Visit AdoptUSKids.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUS Kids, and the Ad Council.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Right now, our country feels divided, but there's a place where people are coming together.
I was nervous to talk to someone so different than me.
Me too.
Love Has No Labels and One Small Step are helping people with different political views, beliefs, and experiences connect through conversation, and it feels good.
This conversation gives me hope.
It gives me a lot of hope, too.
Take a step toward bringing our country and your community together.
We've only had
start a conversation
11
at
combined shutouts
/one small step. A
since
message 2020. Love Has No Labels in the Ad Council.
I believe that.
LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball from the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Dylan Cruz will lead it off for LSU as we head to the bottom of the third inning. Tigers lead 3-0 over Central Arkansas. Cruz with a two-run bomb over the right center field wall, his sixth round tripper of the year. And the first pitch is a strike on the inside corners. He'll face Dylan Yannick for the first time tonight. That home run come off the starter, Oliver Loftman. Here's the 0-1. Slammed and a base hit through the six hole into left field. Dylan Cruz now 2-for-2. Maybe not happy with a 5.08 or 5.15 batting average.
I'm so glad that like the major leagues can't like just draft him right now and pull him out midseason, because I mean he's just so good up there at bat. There's really no more words to, you know. He just raised his average again from 5.15.
Now we'll see Tommy White. First pitch to Tommy. Inside for ball one. Strikeout victim. Only the eighth time this year in 63 plate appearances. So another rarity there as White has Cruz at first. Here's the 1-0. He loads up, pops it up.
Not
shallow
easy.
Center field coming in.
Long
still
way
running,
run.
Still running. It's going to drop between Seldom Ridge and Sear. Bowman, the shortstop, was trying to get out there, but it looked like he was going to yield to Seldom Ridge, and then Sear, the left fielder, comes over, and it drops right between the two of them, and Tommy White will arrive safely at first base, and there's runners first and second, nobody out.
The wind didn't help, okay? It brought it, but that was a major league pop fly. I mean, it had some serious hang time on it, and, you know, that's one of the ones you kind of slap your forehead if you're Nick Harlan, the head coach for the Bears. Should have been an out, but not an easy play off the bat just because it was hit so high in the air.
Yeah, no question, because Seldom Ridge, number one, was playing deep in center.
Yeah.
So he had to get to it. But then the wind kind of shifted from what we thought would be straightaway center to left center. And then it just, nobody got a glove on it. So, again, LSU got the leadoff man aboard with Cruz. White arrives safely on a ball that lands in left center field. And now we see Trey Morgan, who had a base hit in the first inning. Off speed, strike at the letters, and it's nothing and one as that one floats in at 75 miles an hour.
Yeah, and that's the first cheapy of the game, we'll call it. In terms of hits, that's seven on the game. That's the first one that probably could have been an out.
Here's the 0-1 to Morgan. There's a strike again, almost same pitch, letter high, and it's nothing and two.
Yeah, two breaking balls way up there. in the strike zone. By the way, Dylan Cruz extends his hitting streak to 19 games, and he has now reached base in 21 games.
The 0-2 to Morgan. This time he'll take a swing and foul it out of play left side. Still nothing in two.
Trey Morgan also extends his reach base streak to now 20 straight. Has Dugas been on yet? Not yet. He's at 19 in this game. And Tommy White extends his hitting streak to 15 games.
Runners take their lead, first and second. This time the pitch sails too high. It'll be one ball, two strikes to Morgan. Fans get low-rate, long-term financing right now on powerful Kubota tractors, mowers, and utility vehicles. Visit LSUKubotaDealers.com for your nearest Kubota dealer. Test drive a Kubota today. Cruz at second, White at first. The pitch to Morgan. In on the hands, and he sends it back into the screen. Still one ball, two strikes.
Yeah, you know, the first two breaking balls that he threw Morgan, the hangers that kind of caught the top of the strike zone, the second one fooled him. The first one was just not a good pitch to swing at in your first pitch. But now that would be a bad mistake.
Yannick's 1-2. Low and outside. That'll even the countdown to Morgan. Yannick looks back to second. Now the 2-2 pitch. Off the end of the bat, launched to right field. Colby Johnson coming in will make the play and whips it into the infield to third base quickly. Everybody stays put first and second. Sharply hit, but right at the right fielder, and there's one gone here in the bottom of the third inning.
Yeah, got it off the end of the bat. Got him out there on his front foot, off balance, to chase a pitcher's pitch, a breaking ball that started on the outside corner and finished off the plate. Morgan actually did a great job just to get the bat on it.
Dugas gave one a ride to right center. A fantastic play by Kate Seldomridge on the run. Made the grab. He was able to double up Morgan to end the inning back in the first as Dugas comes to the plate. The first pitch short of the plate, and it's 1-0. Chance to add to his RBI totals. Got 17 on the year. Cruz with plenty of speed down at second base as the pitch to Dugas inside for ball two. And Yannick dealing anywhere from 74 to 79 miles an hour. He's trying to pick his spots here. Maybe nibble around the zones. Here's the 2-0. Pitch inside and low. Three balls, no strikes to Dugas.
Dangerous, dangerous territory here for Yannick.
One out, bottom of the third, 3-0 LSU leading. Here's the 3-0 to Dugas. He swings, popped up into shallow right field.
Another again, tough one.
Second baseman Leonard goes back, almost spun around, but able to hold on to make the catch for out number two. Is again Colby Johnson, the right fielder, having to come in quite a ways. Looked like Leonard was going to be on an island by himself, and he's able to make the play.
He was definitely on an island. And watching the replay here, very fortunate to make that catch. A nice play by the second baseman.
So now we'll see Jared Jones. He led off the second with a double down the third baseline. Came around to score the third run of the game. Still runners first and second. Takes a big swing, but out in front of that 76 mile an hour, it's nothing in one.
You know, pop-ups are commonly referred to as a can of corn. They're supposed to be easy outs, but when you can see all the stars and stripes on that flag, because of the wind, nothing is routine, especially those major league pop-ups like Dugas and White have had in this inning. Uh-oh.
This one is sent down the line in left, but angling foul left of the pole.
Oh, I feel bad for the guy that parked right there.
So a long foul ball, and it's nothing and two to Jones. So Yannick will take a deep breath with two outs, runners first and second. He'll deliver another to Jared Jones, the freshman out of Marietta. And a swing and a miss. Again, the off-speed delivery. Jones couldn't catch that one. And that'll do it for LSU. No runs, two hits, two men left on. We go to the top of the fourth. It's a 3-0 LSU lead. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Now batting in the cleanup position, Jenny King, the King of Clean.
Tiger fans, Jenny King is a proud partner of LSU Athletics and even more proud to provide you, the players, and every fan that comes to a game here with a healthy stadium that has been cleaned by our team of professionals. Let us clean and disinfect your business. Go to JennyKingCleans.com now. That's JennyKingCleans.com.
Jenny King, the King of Clean.
When you're done listening to the Tigers take another victory, the rest of the city will be waiting. After all, there's a lot more to Baton Rouge than just Saturday nights. From famous historic landmarks to iconic hole-in-the-walls, even some of the world's best blues joints, there's something special around every corner. But these foodie flavors and soulful sounds are just a sample of what Baton Rouge has to offer. Whatever you're into, it's all right here. Go to visitbatonrouge.com and start putting together your post-game playbook.
Southern Air Heating and Cooling is proud to be an official sponsor of LSU Athletics. Their team of AC professionals have been serving the comfort needs of the people of Louisiana for over 25 years. Much like the fans of the Tigers, our commitment to Tiger Athletics and providing great service remains as strong as ever. Southern Air Heating and Cooling. Go Tigers!
Back to the action of LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Start of a nine-game homestand here at Alec Box Stadium. Central Arkansas coming in from Conway. LSU leading 3-0. Blake Money delivers the first pitch to Seldom Ridge as the Bears get back to the top of the order. Center fielder for the Bears grounded out to Dugas his first time up back in the first inning. First pitch missing, ball one. Money fires, jams him, popped up behind home plate. Milazzo going to give it a look, and it will loudly catch the overhang out of play. One ball and one strike. The Tigers hosting Arkansas Friday, Saturday, and Sunday gets underway. First pitch, 7 o'clock on Friday night. Should be in an electric Alec Box Stadium. First home SEC series of the year. Arkansas completing a home sweep of Auburn. One of those five SEC teams swept this weekend. Here's the 1-1. Fastball for Money, a strike, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, a little concerned about the weather on Friday. Otherwise, looks to be a beautiful weekend, but Friday is a little sketchy with the rain.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. Fouled back out of play. Still 1-2. It'll be interesting because, again, all three games going to be televised on the weekend. So a number of people involved in the decision-making progress as we get closer. Process, I should say, as we get closer to the weekend. The 1-2. Tapper off the leg, foul right side. Still one ball, two strikes to Seldom Ridge, who again made a spectacular defensive play to save some runs. LSU with a chance to add to their lead after plating two in the bottom of the first. He made a sensational catch on the run into the wall with Gavin Dugas, and eventually the Bears would double up LSU with Morgan off of first. The left-handed hitter now trying to start something offensively. Here's the 1-2, and it's lifted to center field. Dylan Cruz playing in shallow center. And he came in and lost it. And it will fall behind him. Going to be picked up by Joe Bear. So a rare miscue at center field by Dylan Cruz, who again was not playing very deep in center. He came in and then you can almost see his body language. Uh-oh, I overran it. And it falls behind him.
I'm telling you, look at the flag right now. It is not easy to catch fly balls.
It almost looked like Dylan on the replay also may have lost it because he kind of put both arms out like, hey, Braden, I don't know where it is.
Look, when you're running out there after a ball, what's happening is your eyes are bouncing up and down, and every now and again you can lose a baseball, and that's just what happened to Dylan Cruz. A waste of a great at-bat from Blake Money, who starts it off with a breaking ball for a strike to the second hitter in the lineup, Tyler Monroe.
So it's 0-1, and Central Arkansas going to be credited with their first hit off of Money coming here in the top of the fourth. Monroe grounded out to Morgan unassisted. Infield on the corners playing in. Is Money now going to turn and look back the runner and Seldomridge to second base. Tommy White playing just off the infield cut, as is Trey Morgan at first. Money from the stretch, checks the runner, now the 0-1. Missed inside and low. One ball and one strike.
Blake threw an inning this weekend at Texas A&M. On Saturday, gave up a hit and a run.
1-1. Slap but foul down the line in right. That'll move the count. One ball, two strikes. Monroe looking for his first hit of the season. And this is just his fifth plate appearance. 0 for 4 thus far. Here's the 1-2, and on the hands, and he fouls it back into the screen. This inning brought to you by AccuTemp Services. Don't let AC or heater outages keep you on the bench this year. Text home run to 31996. It's your Tiger tune-up. AccuTemp Services, proud partner of LSU Athletics. 3-0 score, LSU. Here's the 1-2. This is high with a fastball. 2-2 now the count to Monroe. Tigers 3 runs on 7 hits. Central Arkansas scoreless so far. Their first hit just moments ago off the bat of Seldomridge on a pop up to shallow center. Monroe reaches with the bat and sends one down the line in right. This one will head to the corner. Seldomridge will be waved in from third. Around first is Monroe. He'll turn the corner at second. The throw to third, not in time. Tyler Monroe with the second hit for the Bears tonight, and it's a loud one. A triple to score a run, and the Bears are on the board. It's now 3-1.
Yeah, he actually, Blake Money, that is, made a great pitch. It was down and away. And sometimes you got to give credit to the hitter. He went down there and he got it, and kind of a soft serve line drive right over Morgan's head, was able to get all the way down to the corner. And because it was hit so slowly, he was able to get in to third base with really no tag.
So the Bears on the board now. They cut the lead 3-1. Still nobody out here in the top of the fourth. A runner at third. And the first pitch offered up to Colby Johnson's going to be popped up on the infield grass. Morgan right in the mound, gets everybody out of the way, and he will glove it for out number one. Again, it's those little things we've talked about, Doug, multiple times this year. The communication in the outfield and even on the infield. That time Morgan coming over was very emphatic. He had it. Money got out of his way. Dugas got out of his way. And again, you've got a sure-handed first baseman to make the play for out number one.
Yeah, I was always good with getting out of the way, too, when a guy like Trey Morgan called me off.
Evan Hafley now stands in. Grounded out to Dugas. His first time up. Pitch from Money. Misses outside. One ball, no strikes. A runner at third, and Monroe had the RBI triple. Money still work left to do here with just one out in the top of the fourth. Pitch to Hafley. He'll swing. Send one deep to center field. Dylan Cruz running back just shy of the track. Settles under it. He'll make the grab. Tagging up at third will be Monroe. And the Bears will cut the Tiger lead to one. It's now 3-2 on the sac fly RBI from Evan Hafley. Some personnel starting to toil now for the Tigers down in the right field bullpen. AJ Mendolia, a strikeout victim to Money, will come to the plate here with two down, nobody on, and a 3-2 LSU lead.
That's Griffin Herring, the left-hander. Starting to toss a little bit now.
First pitch missing outside from Money. One ball, no strikes.
Yeah, I think it's important to note that this couple runs has really nothing to do with Blake Money.
1-0 pitch, missing low. Two balls, no strikes. 60th pitch of the night for Money.
You could hit 1,000 more fly balls out to Dylan Cruz, and what happened with the leadoff batter of the inning may not happen. He just lost it in the lights. He was able to get over his head, not hit deep at all.
Two outs. Here's the 2-0 delivery from Money. Off speed, but upstairs, 3-0.
Money's up to 61 pitches now. He's thrown 41 strikes.
3-0 delivery on its way. And down the middle for a strike. Take is on by Mendolia, and it's 3-1.
Money was perfect the first time through the lineup. 9 up and 9 down. Had a couple strikeouts.
Here's the 3-1 delivery. Upstairs, ball 4. Money will give up his first base on balls here. With 2 outs on the top of the 4th, the Bears will keep it going. And that's going to bring a visit out on the mound. Wes Johnson, pitching coach, as we told you, spent some time at Central Arkansas. Of course, Arkansas, Mississippi State, eventually Major League Baseball and the Twins before returning to the college game in an absolute coup d'etat by Coach Jay Johnson. Get him to come to Baton Rouge when the Twins were battling for a pennant last year. Great guy, too. It's fun to watch those guys, especially on the road. We get a chance to hang out in the dugout prior to the games and see him interact with the pitching staff, challenge them, give them constructive criticism, as well as sometimes giving them some tough love.
Yeah, you know, I've had pitching coaches before that have told me that the time off the field where you're competing in different ways, you learn a lot about the type of kids that you have. And Wes Johnson's no different in that regard.
Dylan Sear at the plate. The pitch gets away from Malazzo. The throw down to second, and just under the tag, Mendolia arrives safely. Malazzo still made a close play out of that one after it came out of his mitt. He tracked it down left of home plate and fired a burner down to Thompson, but a good slide by Mendolia, able to get in with a stolen base.
Well, I'll tell you why that close play was even more impressive. Mendolia had a huge lead, and he took a huge secondary lead. He was about a third of the way there when the ball hit the dirt, and he was off and moving, and shows you the cannon Malazzo has to still make it close.
Sear takes a swing, can't catch up to that one, evens the count 1-1. Sear was a strikeout victim, one of those two by Money tonight, back in the second inning. Runner now at second, potential tying run in scoring position with two outs. The 1-1, sent back foul into the screen. Money ahead now, 1-2.
Yeah, this Central Arkansas team certainly came in with a pretty good batting average. They're hitting 290 as a team coming into the game.
Two outs. Here's the 1-2. In the air to left field. Joe Bear giving chase. Joe Bear back to the track, and this one sails out of here, and Central Arkansas going to take the lead 4-3 as Dylan Sear with his fifth home run of the year. And LSU had things rolling. Not a big lead, but we're cruising along until the top of the fourth. And now they find themselves down 4-3.
Yeah, that's really a routine fly ball on any other day. But again, the flag from right to left is stretched out as much as it'll go. And here comes Jay Johnson. He will make a call to the bullpen.
So the Tigers will make a change on the mound. Pitching change powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. Number one LSU trailing 4-3 to Central Arkansas. We'll tell you about the new Tiger pitcher. Get back to action in just a few moments. Bears leading 4-3 here at the box. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
It's good to be able to make a change, to never feel stuck. That's why at Cox, we're making a change too. Now Cox Internet plans are flexible, so you can choose to just go with Internet, add TV tomorrow, or home automation down the line. It's easier than ever to get just what you want and nothing you don't. Flexible plans from Cox. Change anytime. No commitments, no penalties. See for yourself at cox.com/internet. Additional services can be added at then current regular rates. All services subject to residential customer service agreement and acceptable use policy. Restrictions apply.
Southern Air Heating and Cooling is proud to be an official sponsor of LSU Athletics. Their team of AC professionals have been serving the comfort needs of the people of Louisiana for over 25 years. Much like the fans of the Tigers, our commitment to Tiger Athletics and providing great service remains as strong as ever. Southern Air Heating and Cooling. Go Tigers!
Tiger fans, with awesome John Deere deals by Sunshine, you'll never strike out. Ask us about tractor packages with 0% financing available. When you're looking for excellent products to help you get the job done, look no further than Sunshine Quality Solutions. Learn more at sunequip.com. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer ends May 28, 2023.
To the action of LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
LSU led 3-0 through three innings, but here in the top of the fourth inning, a very rare misplay by Dylan Cruz in center field started a chain reaction, then a solid triple down the line, score the first run, added another on a sac fly RBI, and then a two-run homer. Moments ago, off the bat of Dylan Sear, give Central Arkansas a 4-3 lead. They've got four runs on three hits, all coming in the top of the fourth. It's Griffin Herring now will take over. The left-hander will face Noah Argenta. Still, there are two outs. That's LSU asking for Herring to get him back in the dugout in quick order. Herring's first pitch, swing and a miss. Downhill fastball gets by the hitter Argenta, and it's nothing in one.
Griffin Herring is a freshman making his fifth appearance of the year. He's yet to give up a run in 2 2/3 inning of work.
Jams him with a pitch inside, fouled above the first base dugout of the Tigers, and Herring quickly ahead 0-2.
In those two innings, he's allowed two hits, no walks yet, and he has a couple strikeouts.
The 0-2 pitch. Good out pitch, but a better eye by Argenta to stay away. That one just off the outside corner with a heater. It's 1-2.
Worth mentioning, a 95-mile-an-hour heater.
The 1-2, swing and a miss. That time brought the fuzz low in the zone, and Argenta down on strike. So Herring comes in, does his job. However, Central Arkansas takes the lead. Four runs on three hits. They leave nobody on. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Tigers will have 7, 8, and 9. Joe Bear, Thompson, and Malazzo. When we continue, this is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Tom has been a teacher for over 40 years. One day, I think one of the students had asked the question and he didn't remember the answer. And I also noticed that he was letting his class out earlier than they were supposed to let out. I was really starting to worry.
Levi and I talked about how it would change our lives, but he was there beside me.
When something feels different, it could be Alzheimer's. Now is the time to talk. Visit alz.org/ourstories to learn more. A message from the Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
When you went car shopping, you meant business. You aced vehicle history searches and test drives. You out-salesmen to the salesman. Now you've got your wheels. If you manage that, you can get your retirement plan on track. Visiting aceyourretirement.org can help. With 401k tips and smart saving strategies, you'll have the info you need to get more for your future. Go to aceyourretirement.org, because when it comes to speeding past financial challenges, you're an ace. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Your home for LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball. This is the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Tigers trail 4-3 to Central Arkansas. Haven't been many times this season the Tigers have trailed during a midweek. In fact, last memory serves, Southern led 4-0 early. As this pitch to Braden Joubert, who leads it off, a called strike from Dylan Yannick. Southern led 4-0, but it just made the Tigers mad. Came back to win 18-4. Pitch to Jobert. Breaking ball from Yannick misses outside. It's one ball and one strike. Jobert blasted a single to right field back in the second inning. Left-hander stands in with a 1-1 count. Yannick fires the 1-1. High and outside. That'll make it two balls and one strike. Of course, the action heating up on the field tonight. Whenever you're ready to cool it down, count on Slow Melt Ice. Colder, cleaner, and longer lasting. Check them out at slowmeltice.com. 2-1 delivery to Jobert. Swung on, but laced foul down the first baseline. It'll even the count. Two balls and two strikes. Jobert again getting the start tonight in left field, batting 267 on the season. Another one of those that Jay Johnson again can plug and play. Left field, right field. Here's the 2-2. Stays away. The breaking ball misses outside and low. That'll fill the count now 3-2.
Yeah, and nights like tonight are important for guys like Braden Jobert because you got to feed these guys some live at-bats throughout the course of the year. That's the tricky part for Jay Johnson.
Payoff delivery. Absolutely hammered but foul. Line drive down the line and right into the seats about three rows deep. That one coming at you quickly. Evan Halfley, the Bear first baseman, playing near the line at first as this one mistimed it, fouls it to the on-deck circle. Still 3-2. But Dylan Yannick has come in again, the left-hander, having some success early. He's given up two hits. Got a .93 ERA, and again, he's going to kind of float it in there anywhere from 74 to 80 miles an hour.
It's really slow.
It's a change of pace. Here's the 3-2, and a swing and a miss. That one at 76, and Jobert couldn't get it. Down on strikes as Yannick records his third strikeout of the night. One gone here at the bottom of the fourth. Well, we talk day in and day out, especially at the SEC level, Doug, about the pitchers that throw not even 92, 94 anymore. We're talking 95, 98, triple digits.
Yeah, it's just kind of average now.
And now you come in trying to hit 74, 75 miles an hour, but Jordan Thompson able to do so. Little bouncer down the third base line, again just out of the reach of Mendolia, and Thompson plenty of speed around second as it's mishandled by Sear in left. He'll stand up at third base with one out. Thompson picking him up, setting him down. And that'll get the crowd into it here at the box.
Yeah, maybe a double with an error down that third base line. But they're not putting an error up on the board. Let's see. No, it just kicked off. It was tough for him to get to. Really not an error, just a bad kick off the wall. So that'll be a stand-up triple for Jordan Thompson.
First triple of the year for the Tigers shortstop. We'll see Alex Milazzo. Milazzo laid down a bunt, almost beat it out to advance runners and actually bring in a run from third. See what he does here as Yannick delivers the first pitch, and it's a called strike as the Bears expected a bunt. Slowly crashing in down the third baseline. They're just off the infield cut here with a runner at third and one out. Milazzo awaits, pitches in the dirt, blocked up by Argenta, and it's 1-1.
Yeah, they have him drawn in on the grass. And the reason for that is they're hoping for a quick ground ball right back at him where they can check Thompson back to third.
Here's the 1-1 to Milazzo. Ground ball. Big hop in front of Bowman. Bowman, the shortstop, will throw to first. No chance for Thompson to advance. He'll stay at third for the second out of the inning. Again, that one blasted right at Bowman, but a good job by the Bears shortstop to make the play that Coach Harlan wanted.
Yeah, it was a good time for a hard ground ball right at the shortstop. Of course, now the defense will move back to their regular position. They will shade Pearson, the shortstop's a couple yards to the right of second base.
So with two outs, Pearson awaits, and the pitch outside, make it 1-0. Pearson today, a base hit in the first, grounded out to the shortstop Bowman in that defensive shift last time in the second inning. Thompson at third, here's the 1-0. Swing and a miss, out of the reach of the bat of Pearson, outside, it's 1-1.
Yeah, that ball was 4 or 5 inches off the outside corner. just shows how tough it is for these Tiger batters to stay back on the off speed.
Two outs, runner at third, the 1-1. Missing high to Pearson, two balls and one strike. Tigers trailing by a run, 4-3. Tigers have not trailed much this season all year. Here's the 2-1, way outside, missing 3-1 now to Pearson.
Yeah, and really, you know, if you're a head coach, you got the SEC weekend coming here. You nailed it. They haven't really had a lot of comeback opportunities. But here's one on the midweek game right before weekend two of SEC play. It's a great opportunity for this LSU team to prove that they can come from behind.
3-1 to Pearson. That's a strike at the belt. That'll fill the count now, 3-2. And Jay has said as much. I mean, he's talked about some of the games where they've had to at least battle. He talked about it Saturday, getting down 4-0 at Texas A&M. And he readily admits this team at times needs some adversity because it's going to come. The 3-2 and a slow roller down the line at third. It's a fair ball. Going to be a tough play. No chance for Mendolia. Thompson in to score, and Pearson with just a slow roller that stayed fair down the dirt track at third, and Mendolia did all he could. He was playing, of course, in the shift. He was almost in the six hole. There was no shot he would be able to make that throw to first.
Yeah, I think if we had the super, super slow-mo, we would see that that ball might have come off the very end of the bat, maybe the cap. It was a spinner down the third baseline as if the best bunt you've ever seen. It literally hit the bag at third. Pearson with a big two-out single there. You got to get him in however you can.
Tie game for all with two outs, runner at first. We'll see Dylan Cruz.
Yeah, he's up to 522 now. Two for two on the night.
One ball, no strikes to Cruz. The pitch from Yannick. Low and inside. Two balls, no strikes.
Just not a good count to be in.
Pearson at first. 2-0 to Cruz. Loaded the bat but held back. They'll say a strike on the inside corner. It's now 2-1.
Went with a breaking ball there. Can't say I blame him.
Yannick, the 2-1. Cruz again stays away. It gets away from Argenta, but Pearson had already committed to stay at first, so he'll stay there. It's a 3-1 count to Dylan Cruz. So the Tigers with two outs. Pearson delivers the dribbler down the line to score Thompson. Of course, without Thompson's triple, none of that happens. Three-one to Cruz. Misses ball four, so add another walk to his total.
Yeah, 24 on the year.
Now Tommy White with a chance here. Get the Tigers back on top with two outs. He's another gentleman that's no stranger to two-out rallies.
With a guy at first and two outs, it's just hard to stomach pitching around Cruz to put a runner in scoring position for this guy.
And time's going to be called as there's going to be a meeting on the mound here, as again has been a lefty warming for the Bears down in the left field bullpen. So Nick Harlan is out there, the head coach. Initially appears to be a lot like Jay. There always seems to be a conversation. Very rarely do you see Jay go out there and make the call before he gets there and at least has a few words with his pitcher. And Harlan having quite the conversation now with Dylan Yannick as the home plate umpire Jeff Beeman out there trying to hurry up the meeting.
Stay with him.
Yep, they'll stay with Yannick. Just going over a couple of things there. Coach Harlan back to the dugout with two outs. Probably not a bad idea to give a little pep talk with Tommy White standing at the box.
Yeah, make sure he understands who's hitting, make sure he understands the situation, and then of course talk about the strategy, how they're going to try to get him out.
White, a strikeout victim in the first, just his eighth of the year. Had a single in the third inning. And he's got Pearson at second, Cruz at first, and the first pitch jumps on a ground ball. Mendolia will throw to second. From third to second, they get the out for out number three. But the Tigers tie it up thanks to Jordan Thompson's triple and Josh Pearson's rolling single down to third. One run on two hits, one error committed by the Bears. It's now a 4-4 ball game. We head to the top of the fifth here at the box. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Hi, I'm Kevin Falk, LSU Hall of Famer. My years at LSU were amazing. I've always loved celebrating with my teammates, especially when someone was serving up some delicious Manda sauce. For a lot of Tiger fans, it's just not game day without Manda in the mix. Serving top quality sausage in original season is Manda's strong side. But it's not Manda's flavor that's always got me running back for more. You get it? Running back for more. After 75 years, the flavor still says it all. Manda Fine Meats, the official smoke sauce of LSU Athletics.
Together, we are partners, setting a new standard for health. Together, we prove that no matter how battle-tested we are, our spirit remains undefeated. Our Lady of the Lake and LSU are creating transformational change and impacting Louisiana with a new standard for healthcare, research, and education. Together, Our Lady of the Lake and LSU are champions for Louisiana. Together, we roar. Learn more at OLOLRMC.com/LSU.
NIL is dominating the college sports scene, and LSU has positioned itself at the front of the pack. But to remain competitive and stay ahead of the rest, we need your support. Bayou Traditions is the official NIL collective of LSU Athletics. Join the tradition and become a member by signing up online at BayouTraditionsCollective.com. Members receive exclusive access to LSU student athletes that you can't get anywhere else. Help ensure LSU remains a leader in the NIL arena. Sign up today at BayouTraditionsCollective.com.
Powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Tie game 4-4. We go to the top of the fifth here at Alec Box Stadium, Central Arkansas and LSU. Griffin Herring, who came in relief to get the final out of the fourth inning, will start the fifth, and the first delivery to Bowman. Misses low and inside for ball one. Of course, Jay Johnson told us before the game the plan was to get Griffin Herring into the game. Maybe had to bring him in before he wanted to after Central Arkansas plated four runs there in the top of the fourth. But by expectations, we would see Griffin, who, again, one of those guys that Jay said we've got to get more live innings of work. Here's the 2-0 shot to center field. Dylan Cruz going back, twisting, and got plenty of room. He'll get to it in time for out number one. So Bowman retired for the second time tonight. We'll see Tanner Leonard, the number nine hitter, who's 0-for-1, grounded out to Jordan Thompson at shortstop.
You know, I could see why Jay Johnson wanted to see Griffin Herring tonight. A lefty with a mid-90s fastball. I'd want to see a little bit more of him as well.
First pitch to Leonard. Uncorks that one from Herring, a little high, and it's one ball, no strikes. Pitch this time inside and low, but a swing and a miss makes it one ball and one strike. Remember, just like the winning lineup, Cintas has the all-star services for all of your business needs, everything from uniforms to kitchens and restroom solutions. Get ready for the workday with Cintas. Another pitch from Herring down around the ankles makes it 2-1. Leonard, a 318 hitter, been one of the stalwarts in the lineup for Coach Harlan so far this year. Here's the 2-1. There's a strike at the knees to even it up. Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, they kind of got this 318 hitter buried down there in the nine hole. One of the highest averages in the starting lineup.
2-2 delivery. Miss low. That'll fill the count now to Leonard. Joking with Jay before the game, I said, so did you guys ever compete against each other, you and Coach Harlan, or were you always teammates? He said, well, for the most part, we were always teammates, certainly through high school. Played at two different junior colleges. So this pitch is low and inside for ball four, so Herring going to give up the walk with one out. Puts Leonard down at first base. He said, we competed a little bit then. And then in true Jay fashion, he goes, but he was the better player.
I was just going to say,
he's the better coach. He's the better coach.
The better coach,
yeah,
too. So he beat you to the punch to ask who was the better player.
He did.
Because it was coming.
He knew it was coming.
So modest.
Back to the top of the order, Seldom Ridge. He's one for two. Had a double in the fourth inning, but first Heron's going to throw over and keep an eye on Leonard, who's 9 of 14 in stolen bases this year. So as Jay told us, Milazzo behind the plate tonight, as he expected. Central Arkansas, should they get runners aboard, they've got some that will try to advance, as the fastball from Herring misses outside, and it's 1-0 now to Seldom Ridge.
We got Gavin Guidry starting to toss now.
Another name Jay told us would pitch tonight.
Who else did he say would pitch?
That was it. Money, Herring, and Guidry. The rest he kept close to the vest. Here's the 1-0. Showing bunt, pulls it back, and a called strike makes it 1-1. Kind of surprised Seldom Ridge. Tommy White at third, playing in on the infield grass. Herring again with a quick throw over to first, trying to keep Leonard close to that first base bag. Mentioned that Central Arkansas making this trip south. Swing and a miss by Herring. Gets Herring, or by Leonard, or I should say Seldom Ridge, gets Herring ahead 1-2. Then they will head east to Jacksonville for A-Sun action this weekend. One out, runner at first. Herring fires to the plate. Off the end of the bat, foul. Rolls to the backstop. Still 1-2. They've got Arkansas State on the schedule. Come back to Louisiana, take on ULM on the 29th. They'll battle Arkansas on April 18th. Midweek affair. Here's the 1-2. Down in the dirt. Nice job by Milazzo to keep a glove in front of it. And we'll keep the runner in Leonard at first base. Now a 2-2 count.
Find me a better quote-unquote backup catcher than Alex Milazzo.
Herring's 2-2 delivery. Runner goes. Milazzo comes up firing. Thompson got it and applies the tag. And Leonard out at second base. Strike him out. Throw him out. And that'll end the inning. Central Arkansas trying to run. But not with Milazzo behind home plate. That'll do it for the Bears. So we remain tied as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. LSU will come to the plate. Trey Morgan, Gavin Dugas, and Jared Jones do up 4, 5, and 6 when we return. 4-4 our score. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Hub International is Louisiana's premier employee benefits and commercial insurance brokerage. Hub can insure just about any risk that your business faces. Did you know Hub even insured the bonuses for our football coaches in 2022? Hub specializes in the construction, healthcare, real estate, and hospitality industries. Chances are you're probably already doing business with someone who does business with Hub. Turn to the agency that the Tigers, Saints, and Pelicans choose. Hub International. Visit them today at hubinternational.com.
Y'all like it hot and spicy? Then play Boil 'Em Up from the lottery. Win up to $3,000. You've hit the bonus round. Play Win It All Bonus. Win up to $17,000. Looking for a jolt of cash? Pick up High Voltage Bingo and win up to $30,000. Stack up your winnings with $200,000 stacks. Top prize, $200,000. The Louisiana Lottery, giving you a reason to smile. Must be at least 21 to purchase.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke fan, so make sure you... Jim. Jim. We're on the air.
Ooh, yes, this tastes like the best Coke ever to me. Your thoughts, Jen?
Well, can I have a sip?
Jen, we're in the middle of reporting the news.
I need to try it first.
Back to the action of LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Trey Morgan leads it off for LSU. Tie game 4-4. Central Arkansas down early 3-0. Took the lead in the top of the fourth inning. A two-run blast off the bat of Dylan Sear. LSU would tie it back up. Jordan Thompson with a triple there in the bottom of the fourth inning. And Josh Pearson able to drive in a run on just a slow roller down the line at third. Thompson coming in from third to score. 2-0 the count to Morgan. There's the pitch and misses outside from Dylan Yannick, who came in relief and has done a very good job. Not overwhelming. Again, his pitches anywhere from 74 to maybe reaching 80 miles an hour. But LSU's had a hard time timing it out. Here's the 3-0 to Morgan. That's a strike at the letters. 3-1. Morgan with a base hit in the first inning, flat out to right field in the third. Batting in the cleanup spot tonight. Goes opposite field, skies one to left. But settling under it is going to be Dylan Sear, and he will have it for out number one. See Gavin Dugas, who's 0 for 2. Gave one a ride back in the first inning to right center field, but a better play by Kate Seldomridge stole that away and eventually doubled up the Tigers to end the first inning.
Yeah, that ball to right centers, minus Cruz's home run, maybe the double by Jared Jones, one of the hardest hit balls of the game.
Yannick fires, and this one high and outside, ball one. Bear infield going to play straight up here against Dugas, the right-hander. Yannick's pitch, high for ball two.
As Chris said, Dugas is 0 for 2 tonight. Season's average sits at 367. Five home runs and 17 RBIs.
2-0 pitch. There's a strike at the belt, 2-1.
Looks like we're going to see Gavin Guidry start off the top of the sixth inning if I were a betting man.
2-1, way out in front swinging, and it evens the count now 2-2 to Dugas. Two pitch. Put some into that one, got it up to 84, but missed high. That'll fill the count now to Gavin. Dugas, one of those talented players that hustled, worked himself into the lineup. And this one hit a mile high to left center field. Seldomridge got room, and he floats over, gets under it, squeezes it for out number two. And hit that one of the deepest part of the parks in front of the Coca-Cola sign. Left of the batter's eye. Now we'll see Jared Jones, the DH. Here's a guy that came onto the scene blazing to start the season. Batting 371, 63rd plate appearance. Leads the team with seven home runs. Yannick will face him again for the second time, and the first pitch inside for ball one. Jones had that double rip down the line at third base. Came around to score in the second inning to give LSU a 3-0 lead. Yannick, the left-hander, fires the 1-0. This one hammered, look out, it's headed towards the seats.
Oh, watch out.
Hopefully there were empty bleachers down there in left.
I know our fans are just dying to hear the scores around the SEC.
You can hear it from up here. Here's the 1-1. This one lifted in the air, first base side, foul territory, and with some room in. Halfley lost it. Argenta, the catcher, could not get to it. Bounces harmlessly on the turf, and Jones will live to swing again. Halfley was trying to get as close as he could to the track in front of the dugout. Kind of overran it. Then the wind, again, blowing pretty stiff right to left. Brought it right back on him, and he was out of position to make the play. Argenta had just arrived on the scene. So with two outs, still a 1-2 count to Jones. Semi-shift on to the left side of the infield here for the right-handed hitter. Here's the 1-2. In on the hands, good eye by Jones, and it's 2-2.
four games around the league have already gone final. One surprise.
Two outs, the 2-2 pitch, and a ground ball foul behind or down the third baseline.
Arkansas defeated Southeast Missouri State earlier 12-2. Kentucky beat Eastern Kentucky in Lexington by a score of 9-3. Georgia won over Georgia State on the road tonight 8-3. And the upset of the night, Charlotte defeats 11th-ranked South Carolina by a score of 6-2.
2-2 pitch to Jones. Too far inside. We'll fill the count now, 3-2.
Another potential upset is brewing in the top of the seventh inning. In Tallahassee, Florida State Seminoles lead Florida by a score of 5-3.
4-4 our score, bottom of the fifth, two outs. Jones at the plate, here's the payoff pitch. Low and inside, ball four. So a two-out walk for Jones. He'll reach base by way of base on ball, second time tonight. Then he'll be aboard, and we'll see Braden Joubert. One for two, base hit in the second, had trouble timing out Dylan Yannick last time. He was a strikeout victim in the fourth.
You know, that was another great at-bat from Jared Jones. He has had two strikes on him a couple times tonight, fouled off several to stay alive. He draws the walk there.
So he'll take his lead off first. Yannick will fire to the plate. Joubert stays away, and the pitch misses off the plate. 1-0. Yeah, it really shows you a lot of maturity for Jared Jones. I mean, again, nobody going to be surprised by his power. They all scout him now. Probably not going to see a lot of them thrown right over the fat of the plate. This one misses outside.
Yeah,
and again, they're going to try to nibble, and you've got to have a good eye at the plate.
I'm proud of him to draw a walk at all. If I could hit a ball as far as that, I'd swing it every pitch.
2-0 the count to Joubert, who also can punish a baseball.
Indeed.
With two outs, the 2-0. Again, trying to stay on that outside corner, but yet to find it. It's now 3-0. Yannick behind in the count. Pitch. There's the strike. Joubert putting the onus on the left-hander. It's now 3-1. So he'll step out momentarily, regrip, and dig back in. Two down here at the bottom of the fifth in a tie game, 4-4. Pitch from Yannick. Outside, ball four. That one elevated as well. So back-to-back walks, and runners first and second here are still two outs, and now Jordan Thompson. They initially, like the score may went in and changed. I thought they were going to give him the stand-up triple. In the official scores book, they have him with a double and an error, but initially they did not put an error up there. But
I'm going to have to go rattle some cages down there. The ball kicked off the wall. Can't give that an error on the guy.
So runners first and second with two outs. Thompson, first pitch in at the knees for ball one.
Flags are good for a home run out to left center right now.
Yannick fires, big swing, high in the air but fouled on the line in left. Jordan was thinking the same thing.
Yeah.
Just didn't line it up, and it's 1-1.
Had the distance. Look how big Joe Jones is compared to that second baseman.
He's a bear.
Oh.
That's what they call him.
I'd like to see him with a football helmet and some pads on.
My guess is so would Brian Kelly.
Probably so.
Here's the 1-1. And this one hit to left center field. This one back deep. This one is out of here. Jordan Thompson agreed with you wholeheartedly. Park couldn't hold it. His second home run of the year. Three-run bomb, and the Tigers regain the lead. It's now 7-4 LSU.
Yeah, he just snuck it out 343 feet. In the paper tomorrow, it'll just be a home run. Jordan Thompson now with a couple extra base hits. A three-run home run, just what the doctor ordered. without that win, I don't know if that one gets out. I think it's off the top of the wall or off the middle of the wall, but I'm not sure if it gets over the top without that little extra push.
That may be all for Dylan Yannick, who again had a really good relief outing going here until the Tigers get to him in the bottom of the fifth inning as Coach Nick Harlan on his way out there. And this one, a slow walk with a 30-second meeting. This is the second meeting him and Yannick have had. He makes the call to the bullpen. So a pitching change for the Bears, powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. LSU back on top, 7-4. Doing it all with two outs here in the bottom of the fifth inning. We'll continue after this. Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Hey, Tiger fans. Don't miss out on the latest John Deere deals from Sunshine. Ask us about tractor packages with 0% financing available from Alex Box Stadium to your own backyard. The grass is always greener behind the wheel of a John Deere. Learn more at sunequip.com. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer ends May 28, 2023.
It takes true grit to wake up every morning dedicated to a higher standard of work. At H&E Equipment Services, we're leveraging our national fleet of equipment with a local approach, working closely with customers to understand their needs and provide them reliability, fair prices, and the support of a first-class service team. We're an equipment company. Run by equipment people. Where others stop, we continue. H&E Equipment Services, the higher standard in equipment rentals, sales, parts, and service.
Y'all like it hot and spicy? Then play Boy Love Up from the lottery. Win up to $3,000. You've hit the bonus round. Play Win It All Bonus. Win up to $17,000. Looking for a jolt of cash? Pick up High Voltage Bingo and win up to $30,000. Stack up your winnings with $200,000 stacks. Top prize, $200,000. The Louisiana Lottery, giving you a reason to smile. Must be at least 21 to purchase.
Your home for LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball. This is the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Tigers tonight with two home runs. Dylan Cruz in the bottom of the first inning to give the Tigers a 2-0 lead. And then after they fell behind for the first time in a midweek game this year, 4-3, they were able to tie the game up. And then Jordan Thompson, his second home run of the year. And again, 37th of the season for LSU, gets them back on top 7-4 with that three-run blast to left center field. So here we are, 7-4. We go to the top of the sixth inning. Central Arkansas, or rather LSU, continues here with two outs. They make a pitching change in the bottom of the fifth inning. Again, LSU, no stranger to two-out rallies. They have to call upon Peyton Windham, who will make his return after missing some time. So he will face Alex Milazzo, who stands in. Another left-hander for the Bears, and the first pitch to Milazzo. Down around the cleats, inside, ball one.
Yeah, Peyton Windham actually started out the year as one of their weekend guys. Had some shoulder soreness about midway through February, so they've shut him down since then. This will be his first outing back. Their radio guy just came over here to make sure that we knew he may be a little rusty, although I thought he might have had a chance to knock a little of that rust off because he had to throw close to 60, 70 pitches down there warming up.
2-0, and there's a strike to Milazzo. Alex tonight in the nine spot, 0-for-1. Drove in a run on a sack bunt in the second inning. Beautiful bunt, and almost beat it out. Grounded out to the shortstop back in the fourth inning. That one skips off the dish. That'll make it 3-1 now to Alex.
Yeah, so this is a big outing for this team to see if Peyton Windham is back at full health. Everybody can use a weekend starter back.
3-1 pitch. Misses inside, ball four. So give up the walk to Milazzo. Keep the inning going here. Still two outs remaining. By the way, Peyton Windham, talk about being a weekend starter. He started against Vanderbilt.
Yeah.
Gave up just one unearned run at 4 2/3. In that win, 5-4 for Central Arkansas. Back on February 21st, so I'm sure Coach Harlan happy to see and keeping a close eye on his left-hander here against the number one team in the land as Josh Pearson atop the order will come to the plate. Time called as home plate umpire Jeff Beeman maybe giving Josh a little extra time. Lazo short lead off first and the pitch to Pearson. Missing low. One ball, no strikes. Again, it's time to visit your local Kubota dealer. See why Kubota, the number one rated reliable tractor under 100 horsepower in the U.S. of A. Visit LSUKubotaDealers.com for your nearest Kubota dealer. Test drive a Kubota. The 1-0 to Pearson. There's a strike at the letters. 86, 87 on the gun. It's 1-1.
I think we could call the Kubota guys, let them go down and see if they'll let us go down there one day and move some dirt around, test those things out a little bit.
Could be fun.
Yeah.
1-1, ground ball hit towards second. Scooping it up is going to be Leonard. He will throw to first, and that will finally bring the fifth inning to a close. However, LSU regains the lead. Three runs on one hit. It was a three-run blast to left center field off the bat of Jordan Thompson, and the Tigers lead again, 7-4. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
When you open a crisp, cold Bud Light, you know game day is here.
Touchdown! You owe me $5.
We mean every sound. Enjoy responsibly. 2022 Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Hey, Tiger fans, your new favorite local delivery app is here. Download the ASAP app to get all of your game day needs delivered right to your door. All season long, make sure to use promo code TIGERS22. You'll score $5 off your order and automatically be entered in the winner ASAP Dinner Sweepstakes for a chance to win tickets to see the Tigers in action. That's promo code TIGERS22. ASAP.com is the official mobile ordering partner of LSU Athletics.
When you open a crisp, cold Bud Light, you know game day is here.
Touchdown! You owe me $5.
We mean every sound. Enjoy responsibly. 2022 Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Are you one of many homeowners who just dreads the winter due to inconsistent home heating? Perhaps you're an HVAC contractor who just wants to offer more reliable, higher efficiency home heating. Luxair helps keep homes warm while saving money and offers great business building programs for contractors too. Contact your Luxair dealer to find out more. Or if you're a contractor, visit SolarSupplyLuxair.com to learn about working with Luxair.
Your home for LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball. This is the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Top of the sixth inning, LSU leading over Central Arkansas 7-4. Leading things off will be Tyler Monroe. He had the triple to drive in a run there in the fourth inning. Came around to score himself when Central Arkansas plated those four runs. Take a 4-3 lead. This pitch missing outside from Herring. It's now one ball, one strike to Monroe. Batting an even 200 now. Left-handed hitter. It's a lefty-on-lefty matchup. Herring winds and the 1-1. Missing outside, make it 2-1. Herring, the highly heralded freshman left-hander out of Southlake, Texas. Couple of big Texas arms making their way here to LSU this season. Off the end of the bat, this one sent to left field. Joe Bear sails back a couple of steps. He'll have it. One down.
And I thought we would see Gavin Guidry start off this inning because he was full bore down there in between innings. A lot of times when you see that, when your team's up to bat, that means that guy is getting hot to go in. But looks like he was just finishing up, getting loose. Now he's going pitch for pitch.
Batting third in the order, Colby Johnson, 0-2. Ground out and a pop out. Takes a big hack, but can't get around on it. 94-mile-an-hour heater from Herring, and it's 0-1. Chase Shore is the other highly heralded freshman out of Texas. As this one sent foul into the screen. Additions to this LSU pitching staff, which we've talked plenty this season about the difference in depth in 2023 to 2022.
Well, Herring's a great example.
The 0-2, got him in on the hands, lifted into shallow right field, giving chase, diving for it is going to be Pearson, can't come up with it. Morgan will pick it up, throw to second, got away from Thompson, as Johnson will stay put right there. Again, just put it where nobody could get to it.
That's the one right there. You could draw an X about right where that ball landed, and it's going to give any defense on earth trouble. It's no man's land. You've got first baseman on a weird angle going straight back, second baseman and the right fielder with a lot of ground to cover. And then there's got to be a lot of communication, very clear communication when that's happening as well. And more times than not, we see that one find some grass.
So with a runner at second and one out, see Evan Halfley. Halfley 0 for 1. Had a sac fly RBI back in the fourth inning as this pitch from Herring sails outside of the right-hander. It's 1 and 0. So Johnson with a one-out double down at second base. Herring checks the runner now to the plate. Lifted foul out of play right side. Milazzo will give it a look, but it will catch the overhang, and it's one ball and one strike. You can see now Coach Jay Johnson, not just because he knows Coach Harlan, really said this is going to be a good team coming in here. A team that will not be intimidated by the surroundings or the name on the jersey, LSU. And they're still swinging here, down 7-4. Plenty of baseball left. One ball, one strike. Halfley, the right-hander, awaits. Herring fires and drops to a knee trying to find it. Swing and a miss, 1-2.
Yeah, you know, at this level, intimidation isn't really a thing. Now, when the score's 10-0, it gets a little different. Or perhaps when Paul Skeens is on the mound, maybe there's some intimidation. But, you know, these teams that come in that are the underdogs, this is the one they circle on their calendar. They're wanting this win as badly as any other win in the year.
One out, runner at second. The 1-2 from Herring. Got him to chase in the dirt inside. Swing and a miss. Halfway down on strikes. As Herring records his third Super One Food strikeout. Records out number two at the top of the sixth inning. Again, if you're just tuning in, no 10-run rule in effect tonight. Both coaches agree to play 9 innings. Right now it's a 3-run game, 7-4. Leading hitter for the Bears, A.J. Mendolia stands in. He's 0-for-1, did get aboard on a walk the last time in the fourth inning. He's got a runner at second, but two outs now as Herring will turn and look back the runner to second.
You know, freshman or not, what I'm seeing from Herring so far, I've always said 90-mile-an-hour left-handers play in college baseball. Herring's 93-plus. He's been up to 95 tonight. Very impressive so far.
This pitch low. Milazzo going to fire it down to second. Dugas just has to get in front of the one-hopper and knock it down. There's Johnson back safely. That's
yeah,
what that, Milazzo
that's not your
do.
Average one-hopper either. That thing's got some mustard on it. Nice play.
One ball, no strikes. Herring to the plate. In the air to, again, shallow right field. Everybody converging. Pearson and Dugas nearly collide.
That's great communication.
But Pearson able to hold on for out number three. A dangerous moment, but Dugas spins out of the way, does a somersault, avoids a collision, and the Tigers head back to the dugout with a 7-4 lead. We head to the bottom of the sixth inning. It'll be Cruz, White, and Morgan. 2, 3, and 4 hitters due up. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
It's 4 a.m., Monday, and you're literally sucking baby snot through a tube because she's congested. Man, that's love. And if you love her that much, love her enough to make sure she's buckled in the right car seat. To make sure your child's in the right seat for their age and size, visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Show them you love them. Keep them safe. Visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Papa, why can't we telegraph while riding a horse?
Son, there ain't no one to blame but Jeffro. He was riding old Betsy the Stallion, tip-tapping away at his telegraph, when blam, ran right into the side of the saloon.
Well, if Jeffro can't do it, neither should you. Don't text and drive.
Visit StopTextStopWrecks.org. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
LSU comes to the plate, bottom of the sixth inning here in this midweek affair against Central Arkansas. Tigers led early, got behind by a run, 4-3, but now have stormed back to take a 7-4 lead as Dylan Cruz will lead it off. Dylan doing Dylan things once again tonight. Had a two-run homer in the first to give the Tigers a 2-0 lead. Base hit on the first pitch he saw in the third, and then aboard on a walk in the fourth inning. First pitch missing inside and low from Windham. Second pitch does the same, and it's two balls, no strikes to Dylan Cruz.
And he just keeps getting in these 2-0 counts.
2-0 pitch, that one missing maybe a tad low on the outer half. 3-0.
Comes walk number 25 on the year.
3-0 pitch. Green light on. He swings and fouls it to the backstop. 3-1. Tiger fans, get ready to taste victory with a Victory Grill from Barbecue Guys. Get your Victory Grill today. Become a backyard barbecue champ only at bbqguys.com. Hitters count for Cruz. The 3-1. Missing low, and indeed a base on balls. Second straight for Cruz. Reached base all four times tonight. And the leadoff man aboard for Tommy White. As White steps to the plate, 1-for-3 on the evening.
And you know what I like about Cruz the most? You know, with a guy with kids who are watching these guys as if they're baseball gods. He's not a bat flipper. He's not, you know, flamboyant. He just goes out there and gets the job done every single game.
No, he's a pack-a-lunch guy. Just go out and get the work done. Success will speak for itself. It's the pitch to White. Misses inside. One ball, no strikes. In Austin, we were loading the buses. Dylan, one of the last to get out of the showers, and there were probably 5 to 6 Longhorn fans under the age of 10, and they were all hanging out at the center field fence. And each player that come out, they'd look. No.
Wait for number three.
Dylan walked out. They went running to him, and he spent probably 5 to 6 minutes talking with them. And again, they're decked out in Longhorn gear. Took pictures, signed autographs. Great human being. 1-0 to White. Missing low, now 2-0.
Yeah, I mean, he's a superstar. That's really all there is to it. And I know that, too, because, you know, I'm doing the youth baseball circuit and Central and all over the great state of Louisiana watching my sons play. And
2-0 misses low, now a 3-0 count. So Windham, back-to-back batters now, gets behind in the count.
At this point in the year, we're at about 65% of the kids standing there like he does with the bat barrel pointed down at the ground until he's ready to load. You know, I figure by June, it'll probably be about 95% of the kids standing in there like number three.
Ball 4 to White. So now back-to-back base on balls with nobody out. LSU putting runners first and second. I have to imagine it's a little different for you as well when maybe years ago people wanted to know about your LSU career. Now they probably ask, you know Dylan Cruz, right?
Oh, yeah, all the time. All the time. Can you get Dylan Cruz an autograph? You know, the whole deal.
Another change coming here for Central Arkansas. Peyton Windham's time is done on the mound. So a pitching change powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. LSU up 7-4. Trey Morgan coming to the plate with runners first and second. Nobody out. We'll tell you about the new Bears pitcher after this on Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Tiger fans, with awesome John Deere deals by Sunshine, you'll never strike out. Ask us about tractor packages with 0% financing available. When you're looking for excellent products to help you get the job done, look no further than Sunshine Quality Solutions. Learn more at sunequip.com. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer ends May 28, 2023.
Albertsons is making shopping and saving easier than ever. Just For You Deals is now Albertsons For You. It's everything you love about Just For You with all new perks. Get rewarded for just being you, including personalized deals, a free item every month, and even a treat on your birthday. With Albertsons For You, you earn points every time you shop and redeem them for discounts on groceries and more. Brand new Albertsons For You members receive $5 off their next $25 or more purchase just for signing up. Download the Albertsons app or simply update your existing mobile app to see your all new, all awesome perks. Albertsons, fresh foods, local flavors. Support your LSU Tigers with Hancock Whitney, the official bank of LSU Athletics. From game day to the offseason, Hancock Whitney LSU credit and debit cards are a big win for any Tiger fan. Want to get your paws on these cards? Well, apply online or visit HancockWhitney.com/LSU. Hancock Whitney Bank, member FDIC. All accounts subject to credit approval. Terms and conditions may apply.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
New pitcher takes over for Central Arkansas. Here in the bottom of the sixth inning with LSU leading 7-4, the Tigers able to pick up two walks off Peyton Windham to start this inning. Cruz at second, Tommy White at first base. Trey Morgan set to come up, and he will face Trent Gregson, a right-hander for the Bears.
Gregson is a junior, making his eighth appearance of the year. Got a lot of work in his first two seasons as a freshman at 17 appearances. Last year, his sophomore year, had 22. Already at 7 this year. This year is 17 innings pitched. He's allowed 21 hits, 17 runs, 15 have been earned. He has 12 walks and 21 strikeouts.
Trey Morgan stands in, righty on lefty matchup, and the first pitch from Gregson, a called strike, and it's nothing and one. Gregson out of Longview, Texas. His father, Terry, played basketball at Stephen F. Austin. His mother ran track at Laterno University.
A little surprised at the pitching change here.
Morgan slaps one down the line, plenty of distance, but foul in left.
You know, they had a lefty on the mound with Morgan on deck, and they bring in a right-hander to face him. It's 0-2, so the odds are in their favor that it'll pay off. But still a little meat on the bone, as Morgan's pretty good with two strikes.
Trey tonight, 1-for-3. Had a base hit in the first, couple of flyouts, one in the third, one in the fifth. Runners first and second. The 0-2 pitch reaches out with a bat. It's a ground ball. Going to his right, Leonard flips it to Bowman. A little high, but Bowman able to hold on to get the lead, or rather runner at second in White. That will leave runners first and third, the first out of the inning.
Yeah, it ended up being a nice play, but it was risky. Kind of held in the web a little bit too long for Leonard. Almost flipped it over Bowman's head at shortstop. He actually did a nice job of getting back down to the bag quickly to at least get that lead runner at second. But the Tigers will have first and third here with one out.
So now Gavin Dugas, who's 0-for-3, due for something here. First pitch stays away, and it drops in low for ball one.
Another game has gone final in the SEC tonight. Tennessee tosses a shutout over Western Carolina. They went 7-0.
1-0 pitch. Almost got Dugas, and they'll say, wait a minute. They're going to say a ball?
Yep.
They're going to roll a ball. So I thought they were checking to see if Dugas was touched by the pitch. He was not. But that will bring Cruz in, and that'll make it an 8-4 LSU lead as the balk is set to Trent Gregson. Home plate umpire Jeff Beeman rose quickly, made the call. I think Dugas was saying, yeah, it hit me, and then realized that wasn't what he was.
Never mind. No, it didn't.
That'll advance Trey Morgan to second base. So with one out, runner in scoring position, the pitch to Dugas high and outside, ball two. There's a, looks like a couple of pitchers, at least one throwing from the mound, one maybe just soft tossing at this point.
All kinds of stuff going on down there right now. One guy just kind of standing on the mound.
3-0 misses. Should be a 3-0 count now. Is that missed high?
Well, the one. Well, the second pitch almost hit him. It was 2-0 there. Then there was a 3-0. I could swear that was ball. Oh, well, one of them was a ball.
Took a ball. Yeah. Took the pitch away. Yeah. The 3-0. Big swing, but just got a piece, but in the mitt of Argenta. And it will be 3-1 now to Dugas. So now he'll get settled in. With only one out and a runner at second. One run in by way of Balk. Balk Cruz in to score. 3-1. Breaking ball catching the corner at the knees, and it's now 3-2. Dugas a little surprised. Tiger fans
respectfully disagreeing.
That's the way to put it. Payoff pitch up coming from Gregson now. On its way. Upstairs, ball four. So Dugas eventually earns the base on balls. And that moves runners first and second here with one out. And you'll see Jared Jones come to the plate. Jones tonight, 1-for-2.
Thought it might be a good game down in Tallahassee tonight between the third-ranked Florida Gators and the Florida State Seminoles, and it is. 5-4 right now. The home team, Florida State, holds the lead. They're in the top of the eighth inning. Some blowouts, bottom of the eighth, Alabama leads UAB 9-2, and Mississippi State up 16-2 against Arkansas State. Both of those almost have gone final.
First pitch to Jones. Strike called at the belt, nothing and one. Jones tonight a double in the second, came around to score, had a strikeout in the third against Yannick, and then a walk last time in the fifth. The 0-1. That one tails away. A swing and a miss. Nothing to two.
I love the crowd effects with the swing and miss. It's like the Mighty Casey at bat when this guy goes up there.
For good reason. Yeah. 7 home runs. 5 doubles. Driven in 29 runs on the year. Nothing to two. The pitch. And a swing and a miss.
There.
Again. Dropped off the table. Jones unable to get it with the bat. Down on strikes for the second time as Gregson records his first punch out. Two gone. And we'll see Braden Joubert. Joubert 1-for-2 getting the start tonight in left field.
Yeah, you feel like Joubert is kind of due for a home run too. It's been a while. See if I can track down the last time he's put one in the parking lot.
Got runners first and second with two outs. Gregson the right-hander, Joubert the left-handed hitter. First delivery. Inside, missing ball one, 1-0. And going into this weekend, what's great about this team, again, I think the excitement that LSU fans feel, Doug, is the fact that each game they are clamoring to see the starting lineup and who will be where outside of a handful of guys. The 1-2, missing low for ball two.
The last dinger for Joubert actually came on March 11th, so not too long ago. He hit one against Samford, had two home runs versus Sam Houston. And then another against Southern back on February 21st, his first of the year.
2-0 pitch, jammed him, but popped up foul out of play behind us, and it's 2-1.
Buzzy Heidel says Joubert took a tour of Louisiana before ending up here in Baton Rouge. Started off at Nichols, then went to Delgado.
2-1 off the end of the bat, right out in front of the plate. Argenta going to pick it up, throws, and it gets away from Hampley. That'll bring Morgan in to score. Going to go ahead and wave around Dugas, and the throw cut off. And the Tigers will play two more runs. On just a swinging bunt by Joubert, maybe 6 feet in front of home plate. But Argenta had to get out quickly and then step to his left, and the throw could not get Joubert, was down in the dirt. Hafley couldn't dig it, and LSU takes advantage of the miscue.
You know, the double, the triple, the home run, all valuable tools of an offense, but the swinging bunt is one of the toughest of them all to defend, and tonight LSU off of two left-handed hitters' bats have had two of the best swinging bunts I've ever seen. Of course, Joubert won't get credit for a hit there, but give credit to Joubert for his speed down the line, because that's what rushed the throw and ultimately played it two more runs.
Jordan Thompson has the first pitch thrown behind him as he crouches down. That one got loose from Gregson, and it's 1-0. Joe Bear aboard on a throwing error. He made it down to second base. Of course, Morgan and Dugas scored. Three runs here, plated by LSU, coming with two outs in the inning. Again, we've got a runner at second, and the pitch to Thompson, who deposited one over the fence in left center, a three-run homer in the fifth, his second of the year. Also had a double back in the fourth. A fielding error after the fact in the corner allowed him to reach third base. This one misses outside, now 2-1. Actually, the Tigers scored their first run this inning with one out. Those last two with two outs. And again, credit to Joe Bear making that tough play for Argenta. This one fouled back into the screen. That'll even the count to Thompson, 2-2. H&E Equipment Services fans, the official construction equipment partner of LSU Athletics. For all of your rental needs, call 877-700-RENT or visit herentals.com today. Thompson with a good night at the plate, trying to add to it here. 2-2 pitch. Again, launches one to left center field, going back, and on the track this time, Seldom Ridge has room to make the play. Another good ride off the bat of Thompson. But that'll end it for the Tigers after they played three runs on no hits and one error in the field against the Bears. It's now 10-4 LSU. Back after this, this is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
When it comes to investing in your home's comfort, it's never just one thing. You want to make sure you get an air-conditioned system that's reliable, affordable, energy efficient, backed by a strong warranty, and is installed by a dealer you can trust. That's why people who insist on the best choose Trane. Plus, right now, Trane is offering special financing. So what's not to love? Visit TraneSouth.com to find a local Trane dealer today. It's hard to stop a Trane. Subject to credit approval. Ask for details.
When you're done listening to the Tigers take another victory, the rest of the city will be waiting. After all, there's a lot more to Baton Rouge than just Saturday nights. From famous historic landmarks to iconic hole-in-the-walls, even some of the world's best blues joints, there's something special around every corner. But these foodie flavors and soulful sounds are just a sample of what Baton Rouge has to offer. Whatever you're into, it's all right here. Go to visitbatonrouge.com and start putting together your post-game playbook.
Y'all like it hot and spicy? Then play Boy Love Up from the lottery. Win up to $3,000. You've hit the bonus round. Play Win It All Bonus. Win up to $17,000. Looking for a jolt of cash? Pick up High Voltage Bingo and win up to $30,000. Stack up your winnings with $200,000 stacks. Top prize, $200,000. The Louisiana Lottery, giving you a reason to smile. Must be at least 21 to purchase.
LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball from the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Top of the seventh here on this Tuesday night from Alec Box Stadium, and LSU now leading 10-4. As the Bears come to the plate, it'll be Sear, Argenta, and Bowman, 6-7 and 8, due up for Coach Harlan and Central Arkansas. And Doug, we said it, LSU led 3-0, then find themselves down 4-3. After 3.5 here, you said, hey, it may be good for a team to, going into a always tough weekend in SEC play, to have a little adversity, not just be able to come out here, be mechanical, and go through the motions. And LSU now leading 10-4. Still some baseball left to be played.
Yeah, they've scored in every inning except for the third, and now Gavin Guidry is on for the Tigers. Guidry is making his third appearance of the year.
First pitch missing low to Dylan Sear, who had the two-run homer in the fourth inning to give the Bears a 4-3 lead. Was a strikeout victim back in the second inning to Blake Money. The 1-0 from Guidry. Again, drops in low. It'll be two balls, no strikes.
Guidry's out of Lake Charles, Louisiana, a former Bar Buck, Lake Chuck All-Star. Right down the road, a two-way player.
2-0 pitch off the end of the bat. Foul rolls to the backstop, and it's now 2-1.
In his two appearances, Guidry's
Worked an inning and a third. He's allowed one hit and two runs. One was earned. He has a walk and four strikeouts.
2-1 pitch. Trying the outside corner, just missing. Now 3-1.
Oh, Florida has now taken the lead in Tallahassee. They lead it 9-5. Scored five runs in the top of the eighth inning.
That one again misses outside from Guidry, and the first batter he faces in Sear will pick up the base on balls and the leadoff man aboard for Central Arkansas.
Yeah, that's the quickest way to get some action down in that LSU bullpen, to walk the leadoff hitter, and right on cue, catcher starts to move to home plate, and it looks like maybe Sammy Dutton. Let me get in the old binoculars. Yep, Sammy Dutton.
Pitch from Guidry misses outside to the right-handed hitter now, Noah Argenta, catcher for the Bears. 0-2, a flyout and a strikeout last time in the fourth. Here's a big swing way out front, evens a count, one ball and one strike. Talked about Guidry, a two-way player. His numbers just phenomenal at Barb High School. And an 8-0 record as a pitcher last season. Here's one, a little Texas leaguer, drops in shallow left center. So Argenta picks up his first hit of the night, and now the Bears have runners first and second. No outs here in the top of the seventh inning.
Yeah, it seems like old Barb turns out about a player every 2 years, maybe every 2 or 3 years here in Baton Rouge, but they are usually a good one.
So now Reed Bowman, who's also 0-2 in the eighth spot, has runners aboard at first and second. Guidry fires, and this one launched to a right field. Shallow right. Coming in will be Pearson. He'll make the play. And now we'll record the first down as runners stay put at first and second. Now we'll see Tanner Leonard, the second baseman. Earned a walk in the fifth inning. Grounded out to Thompson at short in the third.
He's also made a couple nice plays tonight out at second base.
Guidry checks the runner, now fires to the plate. Swing and a miss, got away from Milazzo just for a second, but he finds it quickly and wisely. The Bears not tempting, and it's nothing to one. So had a pretty good season, did Gavin, on the mound with a .16 ERA, 83 strikeouts, 11 walks, and 45 innings. But he also became the Louisiana High School Player of the Year because he batted .422 with five homers and 25 runs batted in. Is this one outside in the dirt. One ball, one strike now to Leonard.
Yeah, that'll get it done. And that was, by the way, just to be clear, not a 1.16.
Yes.
A point.
Decimal in front of the one.
Like one run all year type thing.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Low and inside. Ball two.
There's a reason for all that. Barb, every year, one of the best, if not the best in the state.
2-1 pitch. Off the plate. Milazzo chases it up the first base line. Again, nobody moving.
And every year, for a long time now, they've been led by a man named Glenn Cicchini, who, needless to say, knows what he's doing over there in Lake Charles.
Well, looks like we'll have a visit from Wes Johnson, the pitching coach. Calls for time. He'll jog out to the mound here with a 3-1 count. Runners first and second and one away.
Yeah, in this situation, you know, the teaching point here for the young pitcher is, man, we've got a 6-run lead. We have to throw strikes. Right now we're in a 3-1 count. You walk the leadoff hitter of the inning, fall behind to give up the single. And by the way, this is the ninth hitter in the lineup. Almost a mortal sin to walk that guy in this situation.
So the meeting all wrapped up. Guidry back up on the bump. Here's the 3-1 pitch, and he gets a chase down in the dirt. The breaking ball, and it's now 3-2.
How about a 3-1 breaking ball to the 9-hole hitter up 6 runs? Things have changed a little bit.
Just a bit. One out, the payoff pitch. Another swing and a miss. Comes right back with it and records the strikeout. Gets a hand from Tiger fans. Guidry with his first Super One Food strikeout of the night. Two gone. Still runners first and second. To the top of the order we go. And Cade Seldomridge, who's 1-for-3, had a double back in the fourth inning. So now a righty on lefty matchup here. Seldomridge digs in, open stance from the left side. Guidry fires. Swing and a miss, breaking ball tailed right into the left-hander, and it's nothing and one.
I don't know if it's a breaking ball or if it's a changeup, or it looks like it has a little bit of a split finger action on it. And, you know, Wes Johnson goes out there. It's a 3-1 count. They went right to that pitch twice in a row, and they started off the next hitter. So here's what I'm thinking about it. First of all, it's obviously nasty. But whatever it is, and I'm going to find out after the game whether it's a split finger or a changeup, it's clearly the one that Gavin Guidry likes to throw the most. They wouldn't have thrown it 3-1 and then again 3-2 in this situation if it weren't the pitch that he preferred to throw.
Coach Harlan called for time and brought over Seldomridge for a quick powwow. Now he's back in. Nothing and one. Guidry fires. This time Seldomridge stays away from one low and inside, and it's one ball, one strike. SEC play starts later this week. On Thursday, as Auburn will host Georgia on the Plains. Everybody else will get started on Friday in conference action as the 1-1. Again, misses low from Guidry, make it 2-1. Tennessee will host Texas A&M. South Carolina will host Missouri and Columbia. Mississippi State, Vanderbilt get together in Stark, Vegas. Alabama and Kentucky could be an interesting one in Tuscaloosa. Ole Miss and Florida, and of course LSU hosting Arkansas. There's a strike on the outside corner. Off speed again from Guidry, and he evens the count 2-2.
A couple more have gone final around the league tonight. Alabama wins over UAB 12-2. And Mississippi State 16-2 winners over Arkansas State.
2-2 pitch. Fouled back. Out of play. Still two balls, two strikes.
Also, Ole Miss defeats Arkansas Pine Bluff in Oxford by a score of 11-1. Rice and A&M are in the top of the ninth. They're tied 7-apiece. Auburn leads South Alabama by a score of 6-5. They're in the top of the ninth as well.
Another 2-2 delivery and a little slow bouncing ground ball. Morgan comes in at first. We'll pick it up. Toss quickly to Guidry, covering for out number three. So the Bears are done in the top of the seventh, and it's time to stretch it out here at the box. LSU leading over Central Arkansas 10-4. Tigers coming to the plate. Milazzo, bottom of the order, then Pearson and Cruz, due up. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
My husband had a gun. Him and his friends would go shooting. The ammunition, unfortunately, was not stored separately. In a million years, we never thought that Emily could. There's a hole in our family that can never, ever be filled.
63 Americans a day die by gun suicide. With safe gun storage, we can give our loved ones a second chance at life. Learn more at endfamilyfire.org. Brought to you by Brady and the Ad Council.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility. But it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Put a frog in boiling water and it'll jump right out. But put a frog in cool water and slowly heat it up, that frog will boil. As veterans, we tell ourselves the lie that we can handle anything. We let the water boil. You are not a frog. If you or a veteran you know needs support, don't wait. Reach out. Find resources at va.gov/reach. That's va.gov/reach. Brought to you by the United States Department of Veterans Affairs and the Ad Council.
LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball from the LSU Sports Radio Network.
After the seventh inning stretch, we head to the bottom of the seventh inning. Alex Milazzo starting at catcher tonight, will bat for the fourth time. Drove in a run back in the second inning on a sack bunt. that he nearly beat out. Grounded out to the shortstop in the fourth and aboard on a walk in the fifth inning. The first pitch from Gregson misses outside to the right-handed hitter, and it's 1-0 to Milazzo. Gregson's pitch showing bunt, pulls it back. They'll say a strike on the outside corner, 1-1. We mentioned that five SEC teams were swept this weekend, Doug.
Yeah.
Which, again, is a little surprising number when you think about the expected parity in the league here in 2023 with so many top 25 teams. That pitch high and outside to Milazzo, make it 2-1. And I guess the most surprising one was Missouri at home, sweeping Tennessee.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, probably the biggest weekend in Missouri program history.
Oh, I'd say.
You know?
The 2-1 to Milazzo. Sharply hit, base hit, gets by a diving Leonard at second base and bounces its way into center field, right back up the middle. Nice piece of hitting by Alex Milazzo, the leadoff man aboard here in the bottom of the seventh inning. You know, the other thing, maybe not as surprising as Missouri-Tennessee, but intriguing, I'll say, is Kentucky's sweep over Mississippi State in Lexington, and mainly because of the way it went down. They played 10 innings on Friday, and Kentucky got the win 6-5, but the next two games weren't even close. 12-3 and 17-3, the Wildcats won as a swing by Pearson is fouled out of play left side. And I don't know if it says more about Kentucky, who is 18-2 now on the year, or Mississippi State, based on the way those games went.
I mean, they're on an 8 or 9 game skid in Starkville. Things are pretty ugly there right now. But I will say this, Chris.
There's a swing and a miss by Pearson. He falls behind 0-2.
Every year, just like everyone else, I take the bait. I take the bait on the preseason rankings. I take the bait on everyone's SEC record when they're 15 games through the season. But finally last year, I can't do it anymore. All I care about is LSU's record, but I'm not paying attention to everyone else.
Here's another high fly ball, shallow left center. This time Leonard, or I should say the shortstop, playing behind second base, but Bowman goes out there to left center and he will make the play for out number one. Pearson retired. Now we'll see Dylan Cruz once again.
But what I'm getting at is this. With what Ole Miss did last year, it just proved to me like the rankings don't matter until it matters at the end, down that home stretch, that last 3 weeks of the SEC regular season. And Ole Miss proved to me that if an SEC school catches on fire and makes a run through the playoffs, there's probably 10 of them that have the manpower, the resources that they would need to go through Omaha and win the College World Series.
Good point.
That's how strong this league is at this point, where even the Ole Miss was ranked 14th at some point in the year at the bottom of the barrel of the SEC, and they come back and win the national championship.
Cruz now looking at a 1-1 count.
But I do know this. If LSU wins every series, they'll control their own destiny, and I like this team with the control in their hands.
Bouncer to third off the bat of Cruz, handled at third by Mendolia, and he will throw to second to get Milazzo for out number two. So on the fielder's choice, Cruz will remain at first, two down, and we'll see Tommy White.
Yeah, that's the first time they've been able to get Cruz out. He's still on first base safe.
Southern Air Heating and Cooling is proud to be an official sponsor of LSU Athletics. Their team of AC professionals have been serving the comfort needs of the people of Louisiana for over 25 years. Much like the fans of the Tigers, our commitment to Tiger Athletics and providing great service remains as strong as ever. Southern Air Heating and Cooling. Go Tigers! Hey, Baton Rouge, don't go to just settle for boring old frozen pizza for dinner. Head over to Fat Boys Pizza, where size matters. Come check out their large pies that measure 30 inches across, but the number scarcely does it justice. When you see their 30-inch pie, your whole world got smaller, and your idea of pizza got bigger. From delicious pizza choices, chicken wings, garlic knots, and so much more, stop by Fat Boys Pizza, located on Nicholson Drive in Baton Rouge, or visit them online at eatfatboyspizza.com.
It's good to be able to make a change, to never feel stuck. That's why at Cox, we're making a change too.
Now Cox Internet plans are flexible, so you can choose to just go with Internet, add TV tomorrow, or home automation down the line. It's easier than ever to get just what you want and nothing you don't. Flexible plans from Cox. Change anytime. No commitments, no penalties. See for yourself at cox.com/internet. Additional services can be added at then current regular rates. All services subject to residential customer service agreement and acceptable use policy. Restrictions apply.
To the action of LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
10-4, LSU leads Central Arkansas. First of a 9-game homestand coming up this weekend. It'll be LSU and the Razorbacks of Arkansas Friday night. Hopefully weather's going to change, at least the forecast. Get underway with first pitch 7 o'clock on Friday night.
Fourth pitcher of the night for the Tigers, Sammy Dutton, makes his second appearance in the last month. Dutton, last year, Chris, hard to believe, a weekend start. Not hard to believe because he doesn't have good stuff. That's not what I mean. Hard to believe that he was a weekend starter and has only had a third of an inning pitched in the last month. Again, back to that depth that this team has that is just so extraordinary. Sammy Dutton out there and what would normally be just an outing to get some work. But for that kid wearing number 17, this is a huge outing for him to be able to prove, to Coach Johnson, to Coach Wes Johnson, hey, I could still get the job done. Don't forget about me.
Yeah, to your point, 18 games last year, 11 starts, and was the Game 3 starter in the final nine SEC regular season weekends. He'll face off against Tyler Monroe in the two spot, who's 1-for-3 today. And the first pitch, he hits foul into the screen. 0-1 the count to Monroe. He grounded out to Morgan at first base in the first inning. And had a triple with an RBI in the fourth and flied out to left field. There's a ground ball. Go to second base, going to be fielded by Dugas. He'll toss to Morgan, and the 4-3 results in out number one.
Dutton makes his fourth appearance. In his previous three appearances, he worked two innings, allowed three hits and two earned runs. He has no walks and three strikeouts.
Defensive change in right field. Paxton Kling, the freshman, takes over in right for Josh Pearson. Jobert and Cruz remain in left and in center. As we'll see Colby Johnson, who's 1-for-3, had a double left stranded in the sixth inning. Nice delivery by Dutton. Catches the outside corner, gets him ahead, nothing in one. 0-1 pitch, slapped hard, but right at White at third. Tommy comes up firing, nice throw to first in time. Two down, so very quickly two outs here in the top of the eighth.
Now this you can live with as a head coach. You got the big six-run lead. You're in the eighth inning, just throw me strikes. A bunch of ground balls, a couple fly balls, I don't care. Just don't put them on base. Sammy Dutton with four pitches, four strikes, and two outs. You really can't do it much better than that.
Evan Hafley now, 0-for-2. Had a sac fly RBI in the fourth inning. But Central Arkansas took that 4-3 lead over LSU. It seems like a lifetime ago. Dutton delivers, strike. Nothing in one. The 0-1 from Sammy. This is low, one ball, one strike. Don't forget TJ Ribs, legendary Louisiana barbecue, home of the Jay Johnson Show. That will premiere on March 27th. That's this coming Monday, 7 to 8 p.m. Here's the 1-1. Dutton comes back with a strike. It's 1-2.
I'd have to go watch that one live.
You should.
I heard they have good baby backs over there.
I think I can probably find some for you. It's the 1-2. Hafley swings to center field. Cruz on the run, able to get there in time for out number three. Cruising, playing deep in center, but fleet of foot gets there in time. And the Bears go in order here in the top of the eighth inning. No runs, no hits, nobody on base. It's still a 10-4 LSU lead. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Jelly. Jelly adjective. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous. As in,
Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same. Visit AdoptUSKids.org, brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUSKids, and the Ad Council.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Right now, our country feels divided, but there's a place where people are coming together.
I was nervous to talk to someone so different than me.
Me too.
Love Has No Labels and One Small Step are helping people with different political views, beliefs, and experiences connect through conversation, and it feels good.
This conversation gives me hope.
It gives me a lot of hope, too.
Take a step toward bringing our country and your community together. Start a conversation at lovehasnolabels.com/onesmallstep. A message from StoryCorps, Love Has No Labels, and the Ad Council.
Your home for LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball. This is the LSU Sports Radio Network.
10-4 as we head to the bottom of the eighth inning. LSU with the lead. And Trey Morgan to lead it off. Trey 1-for-4 tonight. Got a board in the sixth inning on a fielder's choice and came around to score on the balk. Had a base hit back in the first inning. First pitch to Trey, rifle shot foul into the screen down the line beyond the third base dugout. It's nothing and one.
You know, I mentioned, you know, seeing all these kids in Baton Rouge or all around the state of Louisiana. Lots of them standing in there like Dylan Cruz. He's obviously a fan favorite. But this guy right here, also beloved by the younger Tigers around the Baton Rouge area, he has been since stepping foot on campus.
You can see some emulation of Morgan's.
Yeah, we got a ball that might be right on home plate.
Well, that came right down the line.
That was on the plate. I tell you, and I've seen this happen before. When I was a kid, there was a guy named Todd Walker here at LSU. Mm. He had a very unique batting stance and batting style, and I have to admit, I tried it over at Dixie Youth in Biloxi, Mississippi a couple times.
Morgan slaps this one to right field. On the run is Colby Johnson. He's able to get there in time and right. Again, that one just dropped down in front of him, and Morgan just, golly, almost thought he could get by Johnson, but luckily he had enough speed to get it on the bounce. My goodness, Morgan is just a sheer assassin with the bat. And, you know, I talked to Jay on Sunday prior to the game at Bryan College Station, and I talked about, again, how impressive this team is. They can go to all points of the field, right-handers, left-handers. Left field, right field, straightaway center. It's just amazing to watch, again, these young student-athletes be able to handle the bat in the ways they do as this first pitch to Dugas, a called strike, make it nothing and one. When you consider when they arrive on campus, they're 18 years old.
Well, I'll tell you why it's unusual.
Here's the 0-1, and another strike to Dugas at the belt, and it's 0-2.
Fastball away is the pitch that's thrown probably more than 80% of the time over the course of a game. And the reason for that, it's because it's the toughest pitch to hit if it's executed properly.
The 0-2 to Dugas. He stays away from this one that drops in low. It's 1-2.
So having said that, most people end up in college and not the minor leagues getting drafted because they can't hit that fastball away. And you nailed it, partner. There are many, many kids throughout this lineup and sitting in the dugout that are able to hit the ball to the opposite part of the field with as much power as they can the pull side, and that's a great sign of a good hitter, as Dugas, with a great eye there, takes a ball off the outside edge to make it 2-2. But you nailed it, man. They really do a good job of hitting the ball where it's pitched.
Here's the 2-2 out in front, swing and a miss. Dugas like to have that swing back. He knew it, and there's one away as he's down on strikes, and Gregson records his second punch out in relief for Central Arkansas. And it looks like they'll bring a guy off the bench. It's going to be Kate Beloso will come in to bat for Jones in the sixth spot. A fan favorite, certainly.
Yeah. Yeah, this is going to be a role that he's going to play all year. He'll get these at-bats in these moments. And just for the record, every time he does, I'm hoping he hits one out of the ballpark.
First pitch off the plate outside, 1-0. Saw Cade in the team hotel Friday night after the game one 9-0 shutout. He did the Talking with Tigers with Bill Franquez on the broadcast. He reminded Bill, I'm undefeated. We're undefeated when I do the interview.
Really?
There's a strike. Well, he gives it up 1-1.
There's only two guys that have lost with the interview, so I don't know if that's saying too much yet. Does he mean in his career?
In his career.
Oh, well, that's a little different.
The 1-1. This is outside, 2-1.
A great kid, Gatorade Player of the Year in Louisiana, had a freshman year that no one will forget. 10 home runs, all SEC, freshman All-American, all that good stuff, and he's been plagued by injuries, it seems, ever since.
Runner at first, one out. 2-1 to Beloso. Misses inside. Good take by Cade as that one just missed the inside corner. It's now 3-1.
But your national championship teams, Chris, they have a lot of the things that this Tiger team does. They have a great offense. They have good pitching. They play good defense, especially up the middle. But these Louisiana-bred kids like Cade Beloso and Gavin Dugas, also staples.
Runner goes as Beloso trying to drop one in center field, and it does in front of Seldom Ridge. Morgan already around second. He'll come into third. Now Beloso, as the throw comes home, he just watched it, and now he'll make his way to second base. Hustle play by Cade Beloso, who drops the single in center field, and now the Tigers have runners second and third with heads-up base running and just one out.
I wish I could show how Trey Morgan treated that. He was off with the pitch stealing. He heard the bat hit the ball, so he stopped before he got to second. He didn't stop and hustle back to first. He stopped and found the ball. And when he found it, he had time enough to realize it was going to get down. And not only did he get to second base, but he hustled around second when he was able to realize the ball was going to hit grass and make it to third. That was such a great job of running the bases.
So now runners second and third with Braden Joubert at the plate. And the breaking ball inside and low from Gregson makes it 1-0. Braden, 1-for-3. Base hit in the second. Reached base in the fifth by way of walk. Came around to score. And aboard on a throwing error back in the sixth inning. Chance for some ribbies here is the 1-0. Swung on and fouled out of play. Third base side. And it's 1-1. So Morgan led off, singling to right field. Dugas would strike out swinging. Cade Beloso comes in, singles to center field. Unable to advance to second base after the throw went up the line at third. Morgan stands at third. Here's the 1-1. Joubert, this is going to catch him in the foot. He's trying to move the foot out of the way, but got him right on the cleat. So now the bases are loaded here for LSU, already leading 10-4. We'll see Jordan Thompson. Thompson's had a good night, 2-of-4. Double came around to score in the fourth and launched his second home run of the year. Three-run variety in the fifth inning.
Now batting shortstop, Jordan Thompson.
Well, this will be another good moment for Jordan Thompson to hit a ball hard.
Morgan at third. Beloso at second, Joubert now at first. Pitch to Thompson. Sent back into the screen, fouled, and it's 0-1. Flied out to left center field in the sixth. Gave it a ride, just shy of the track. So obviously seeing the ball well tonight. And he has an 0-1 count as he digs back in. The 0-1. Pops him up. Foul territory, third base side. Mendolia over there, but the shortstop, Bowman, found it and brings it in for out number two. So Thompson retired, and we'll see Alex Milazzo. Milazzo, 1-for-2, had a base hit his last time up, drove one right up the middle to center field. And again, this is his 22nd plate appearance, but you mentioned it earlier. With what you get defensively, consider Alex Milazzo, if you will, put it in quotes, the backup catcher. This is his 22nd at bat, and he's batting .333.
Yeah, that'll get it done. And also get him a lot more starts if he's able to keep swinging the bat like that. throughout the course of the year. You know, Alex Milazzo, for you Tiger baseball history buffs, is really Ryan Jorgensen 2.0. He was the backup catcher to Brad Cressy in 2000. Just fantastic defensively.
1-0, a strike to Milazzo, evens it up 1-1.
Didn't quite swing the bat as well as Cressy, but that said, one of those two guys played in the major leagues. I'll give you a guess which one. Not really the obvious choice is a hint.
The 1-1, off speed and there for a strike at the belt. Milazzo thought it was outside. I think the LSU dugout agrees, as well as Tiger fans. But it's now 1-2, 2 down, bases loaded here. Tigers up by 6 runs, 10-4. Gregson fires, and it's a ground ball, and it's just foul. Ooh. Left of third base. Another one that was dancing down the chalk. Just took that last bounce left of the third base bag. Still 1-2. You know, another thing that makes Jay Johnson as great as he is, you're up 10-4. You want your guys going out there concentrating, still being aggressive. And here's an opportunity with the bases loaded. He wants to execute. Camp there, swing and a miss by Milazzo. As Gregson finds the hole in the bat, and that will finish it for LSU. No runs on two hits. They leave three men on. Another error by the Bears, but it's still a 10-4 LSU lead. Last chance for Central Arkansas. As we head to the top of the ninth here at the box, this is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Oh, man, I'm glad you're here. Sit down and visit with me, Mom. I'm making it all ready for supper with my family tonight. I can't wait to hug my grandbabies and pass a good time over some good food. Mmm. Ooh, I better start my rice. You know, it seems like all the best meals start by cooking some rice. Cajun country rice, of course. It's what you gotta have when you're cooking with love. I pick it up down the street at the grocery store, and I can even buy it online at CajunCountryRice.com. Y'all stay and eat. There's plenty, yeah.
Hi, I'm Kevin Falk, LSU Hall of Famer. My years at LSU were amazing. I've always loved celebrating with my teammates, especially when someone was serving up some delicious Manda sauces. For a lot of Tiger fans, it's just not game day without Manda in the mix. Serving top quality sauces and original seasoning is Manda's strong side. But it's not Manda's flavor that's always got me running back for more. You get it? Running back for more. After 75 years, the flavor still says it all. Manda Fine Meats, the official smoke sauce of LSU Athletics.
Hey Tiger fans, 12 and younger, don't miss your chance to be a part of Mike's Kids Club, presented by Shell, the exclusive kids club of LSU Athletics. Join Mike's Kids Club for only $25, get the official Mike's Kids Club t-shirt, free admission to select LSU athletic events, and much, much more. To learn about upcoming events and to join, please visit lsumkc.com. The Mike's Kids Club, presented by Shell.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
We reached the top of the ninth inning. LSU leads 10-4 over Central Arkansas in the first ever meeting between the Bears and Tigers on the baseball diamond. A couple of changes. As we told you, Paxton Kling went in the top of the eighth inning in right field for Pearson. Now Josh Stevenson will check in for Braden Joubert in left field. Also, Ben Napolt checks in at second base as Gavin Dugas' night is done. New pitcher takes over as well. Bryce Collins will come in and try to finish this one out.
Collins making his fourth appearance of the year. He's gone three innings, allowed 4 hits, 8 runs. They've all been earned. His big problem has been walks to strikeouts. Chris, 6 walks in 3 innings, only 1 strikeout.
First pitch, fastball, but just barely missed Mendolia, who slides out of the way, and it's 1-0.
And you can tell Jay Johnson not quite comfortable yet with Bryce Collins throwing strikes as someone is already warming down in the bullpen. It looks like Helmers.
There's one got away from Helmers, rolls all the way to the backstop.
Make sure that's Helmers before we start blaming him on pass balls.
1-1 count to Mendolia, by the way.
It is.
Here's the 1-1. Inside at the hands. Now make it 2-1. Bedoya 0 for 2 tonight, a strikeout victim to Money in the second. Earned a walk in the fourth inning and flied out to right field in the sixth to Josh Pearson. 2-1. There's an overhand breaking ball in for a strike, and it evens a count 2-2.
Yeah, this is the most dangerous hitter in this lineup, 424 on the season.
2-2 pitch in the air to center field. Dylan Cruz spots it, now comes in, gets under it, and he has it. One down, two to go for the Fighting Tigers of LSU here in the top of the ninth inning.
Bryce Collins is the fifth pitcher of the night for LSU. Blake Money started it off. Money turned it over to Griffin Herring. Gavin Guidry would come on next. Sammy Dutton through the eighth inning, and now on to Bryce Collins.
Dylan Sear had the two-run homer in the fourth inning, and the first pitch from Collins to the left-hander misses for ball one. Of course, Collins started his career at Arizona, made 20 appearances and two starts last year for the Tigers. Swing and a miss, smokes that one by him. It's one ball and one strike. Had a 3-1 mark last year, 3.6 ERA. Pitched 32 in a third innings, had 20 walks, 37 strikeouts. Held teams to just a 200 average as this one gets loose outside. Make it 2-1 now to Sear.
Yeah, no, he was good last year. Again, it's just the command problem so far early in this season. And the scoreboard right now, the radar gun isn't quite working properly. Bryce Collins throws the curveball in there for a strike. But the fastball, Chris, looks like it has a little extra life on it tonight.
Yep. So with that breaking ball strike, evens the count. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Just missed outside. That'll fill the count now to Sear. Well, again, it's 1-for-2. A strikeout, a walk, and that two-run bomb. Which, by the way, is his fifth home run of the season. Went around on that one. Tried to hold back, but not fooling Jeff Beeman. And Collins will record the strikeout. Another Super One Food strikeout for this Tiger pitching staff. Two down and one to go for the Fighting Tigers of LSU with two down here in the top of the ninth inning. And that'll bring Noah Argenta batting in the seventh spot. The Bear catcher 1-for-3 tonight. His base hit came in the seventh inning. First pitch from Collins. Down in the dirt, but a swing and a miss. Offering comes up empty by Argenta, and it's nothing and one. Tigers trying to start a new win streak at 13 in a row before the loss on Sunday in game three. The 0-1 foul into the screen. Now Collins in the driver's seat, nothing and two with two outs here in the top of the ninth, and LSU leading 10-4.
Yeah, how about back-to-back strikeouts to put this one in the books?
Collins ready to go, the 0-2. Breaking ball drops in a little low. It's one ball, two strikes. Collins working quickly. Doesn't need a 20-second pitch count.
Nope.
The 1-2 pitch. A foul. Bouncer towards the third base dugout. Keeps Argenta and the Bears in it here. Now still one ball, two strikes. Crowd trying to lift Collins to finish this one out. The 1-2 pitch, breaking ball, just got a piece, wow. And again, foul up the third baseline.
He is just getting a stitch of the ball. I mean, he has barely touched the last two. Collins' breaking ball also has some pretty good break on it tonight.
So, two outs, nobody on. The 1-2. Off the end of the bat, lifted foul territory. Morgan gives chase, and Milazzo giving chase, and it drops down after catching the screen into the LSU dugout. Still 1-2.
I think Milazzo wants to make a great play to finish this game.
Oh, he was trying.
Mm-hmm. They say competition, I'm telling you, brings out the best in the best. And Jay Johnson's got all kinds of competition inside this team.
Another 1-2 pitch.
Whoa.
That one hits the dish, got away from Alex, and rolls up the first base line. So now an even count, 2-2. Bryce looks in. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Again, breaking ball, but just a tad short of the plate. That'll fill the count now.
Yeah, I like the 2-2 breaking balls before that one, or the 1-2 breaking balls before that one. Got to make it a little closer.
Payoff pitch outside in the dirt. And a two-out walk given up to Noah Argenta. Keep the lifeline going here for the Bears in the top of the ninth. See Reed Bowman now. Bowman in the eight spot tonight, 0 for 3, a pop out and a couple of flyouts on the ledger. As they'll bring out a pinch runner here for the Bears. Trey Harris, a senior out of Little Rock, started his career at Arkansas. So he will go to first base. He will run here with two outs at the top of the ninth. Bowman, another right-handed hitter. So righty on righty matchup here in the top of the ninth inning. Collins fires, comes off the bat, maybe off the protection gear of Milazzo, who shakes it off, and it's nothing and one.
Actually, I think that got the thigh without the protection gear. He's tough.
Collins from the stretch in the 0-1. Swing and a miss. Once again, gets ahead, nothing and two.
And Belasso's getting beat up back there. That one skipped off and looked like it got him maybe on the wrist or on the left bicep.
Home plate umpire Jeff Beeman making sure he's all right, having a conversation. Belasso's already crouched, ready to go. Hey, let's finish this one out.
No, the bat came back and got him right on the top of the hand.
The bone on the wrist.
Ouch.
Runner at first, two outs, top of the ninth. The 0-2 pitch. Oh, another breaking ball and just, it got away. That buddy made contact. Milazzo throws to first, but they said it was, he swung through it. I thought he got some contact, but it got loose for Milazzo, went to the backstop. So now there's runners first and second.
Yeah, that was the second strikeout of the inning for Bryce Collins. And it looks like Jay Johnson's going to come out. Quick question for the home plate umpire, and looks like that's all he needs.
So runners first and second as the top of the ninth continues. Collins misses inside to Tanner Leonard, the second baseman, who's 0 for 2 tonight. Got a board on a walk in the fifth inning. You're not kidding, Milazzo working hard back there. I thought for sure that was fouled off the bat the way it went towards the third base dugout.
Oh, where's that?
Wow. Little ball two. That would look pretty good.
Well, and that's the problem, right? If you're not around that strike zone, you're not going to get the one every now and again that crosses. You have to establish with that umpire that you're going to throw strikes.
2-0 pitch. That's a strike. Pop in the mitt, and it's now 2-1. Collins left no doubt with that one.
Nope.
Runners first and second. Two outs, top of the ninth. 10-4 LSU leads. In on the hands, misses, now 3-1. Home fans not liking him. Thought he got the corner.
If he isn't able to get the out here, I bet we see Will Helmers next.
3-1 pitch. Miss low, ball four. Now the Bears have the bases loaded, and immediately Jay Johnson on his way out. And he's made the call before he crosses the first base line. So with two down in the top of the ninth, the Tigers have to make a pitching change, powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. They lead the Bears 10-4. We're in the top of the ninth. Bases now loaded for Central Arkansas. Two outs. Back after this. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Hey, Tiger fans, don't miss out on the latest John Deere deals from Sunshine. Ask us about tractor packages with 0% financing available from Alex Box Stadium to your own backyard. The grass is always greener behind the wheel of a John Deere. Learn more at sunequip.com. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Offer ends May 28, 2023.
Albert Albertsons is making shopping and saving easier than ever. Just For You Deals is now Albertsons For You. It's everything you love about Just For You with all new perks. Get rewarded for just being you, including personalized deals, a free item every month, and even a treat on your birthday. With Albertsons For You, you earn points every time you shop and redeem them for discounts on groceries and more. Brand new Albertsons For You members receive $5 off their next $25 or more purchase just for signing up. Download the Albertsons app or simply update your existing mobile app to see your all new, all awesome perks. Albertsons, fresh foods, local flavors.
Support your LSU Tigers with Hancock Whitney, the official bank of LSU athletics. From game day to the offseason, Hancock Whitney LSU credit and debit cards are a big win for any Tiger fan. Want to get your paws on these cards? Well, apply online or visit HancockWhitney.com/LSU. Hancock Whitney Bank, member FDIC. All accounts subject to credit approval. Terms and conditions may apply.
The powerhouse of college baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Tigers trying to close it out here. They'll call upon Will Helmers to take over on the mound in the top of the ninth. Two outs. But the Bears with runners first, second, and third. And top of the order, Cade Seldomridge to the plate. He's one for four, had a double back in the fourth inning. So Helmers, the right-hander. Seldomridge, the left-hander. First pitch, missing outside. Fastball, and it's 1-0.
Third outing for Helmers. He's worked five innings, allowed six hits, five runs, four earned. He has no walks and six strikeouts on the season.
1-0 pitch. There's a strike at the knees. Evens it up. One ball, one strike.
And another guy that had some time on the mound during the weekend, a freshman All-American, Helmers, competing these days just to get some time.
1-1 pitch outside. Now make it 2-1 to Seldomridge.
Jay Johnson not messing around. Looks like Christian Little starting to toss down there in the bullpen.
2-1 the count. Bases loaded with two outs. This pitch rides in high. Now 3-1.
Yeah, this will make you lose your mind if you're a coach.
Three balls, one strike, and there's a strike at the knees to fill it up now. 3-2, which elicits some noise from the crowd. Two outs, bases loaded. They've got Harris at third, Bowman at second, Leonard at first. Seldomridge caught looking back in the fifth inning. Two outs, top of the ninth. Payoff delivery. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And Will Helmers comes in and finishes the deal. Tigers get the win, 10-4 with the victory. They start a new win streak here on this Tuesday night. They move to 19-2 overall for Central Arkansas. They will now get set, head to Jacksonville, Florida for the weekend. They will get there with an 11-9 overall record. First meeting ever between the Bears and Tigers. It goes LSU's way. Final score tonight at the box, LSU 10, Central Arkansas 4. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Making shopping and saving easier than ever.